And it's another great week to be a Wiley Bulldog. Welcome in, Bulldog fans, to another episode of the Wiley Bulldog Sports Zone. I'm Andy Penny, visiting with the head coach, athletic director here at Wiley ISD, Coach Clay Martin. It's been another great week of Wiley Bulldog athletics, tennis, volleyball, cross country, even a little golf here in the last few days, the last week, and a big football game last Friday, and a big one this coming week is homecoming 2023 for the Bulldogs here at Hugh Sandifer Stadium versus San Angelo Central. We'll start diving into that one as the show continues, but first thing we're going to do is look back to last Friday as the Bulldog football team moved to 2-2 on the year, two wins in a row now, two on the road against quality opponents. 2 weeks ago was Lubbock Cooper. This last week, a 42-32 win versus Stephenville on the roads. We welcome in again Coach Clay Martin. And Coach, that was a fun one in Stephenville last week, 42-32. Congrats on the win. And get your early thoughts on what you thought last Friday.
Yeah, you know, obviously it's a lot of fun to win. Yep. And, you know, and to go back-to-back wins on the road is pretty special. But, you know, we're just happy about how we think our team's improving, yep. How we've made some strides, and thought maybe Friday was a big jump.
Yeah, very, very big jump. And we'll look at the highlights as we go. And you kind of segue to my first question. I know this non-district portion of the schedule you put together as building blocks for what's ahead. Winning is just that much sweeter. But, man, over the course of the last 4 weeks, the building blocks are evident, and you guys just continue to improve.
Well, I think we're developing a team, a team that trusts each other. And, you know, we're kind of learning who we are as a team. And, you know, I think that's a good thing to see this time of year.
So the Bulldogs now 2-2, 42-32. They beat Stephenville. As we dive into the highlights, it was Stephenville who won the toss. They deferred to the second half. So the Bulldog offense would get the football to start the contest. Last week, it was Colin Bruning who scored in the first minute of the game. This week, it was the offense and company who scored right in the first 60 to 70 seconds of the game. As Coach will dive into this, you get backed up after a quick penalty. You've got second down and long, and boy, Bear Ming does a great job. This is what we call the scramble drill, and Derek Evans does perfect with his quarterback.
Yeah, you know, I've worked pretty hard the last week or so on this, and, you know, executed perfectly. They all went to the right spots, and Bear did a great job escaping, and then Derek, a great job, you know, staying in bounds and taking it the distance.
And so we get another look. It looks like it's designed to the left, and they come back to the right, and Derek cuts off his route to get open.
Yeah, it's exactly what happened. Yep. Just a play that they did a good job covering, and once Bear broke the pocket, we had a chance for a big play.
It was the start of the big night for that duo. We'll continue to talk about that. Your defense has a great opening series here, a tackle for loss. And then you put Stephenville in a position they have to go third and fourth down. It starts with an intentional grounding here, and then a big fourth down play by Jacob Smith.
Yeah, big pressure, you know, by those guys on those plays. And big, huge play on a stop. We've gotten a little nickel coverage. Jacob with a good play.
It was 7-3 at the end of the first quarter. Stephenville, the football, we knew there would be a lot of pressure on your secondary. Man, they came up all night.
Yeah, Andre Jerpy played really well. Great play here coming across in front of the receiver, proper hand, and you know, just a great play.
10-7 Stephenville at this point. Your offense gets going. It starts with a run game. Malachi, big run. Bear Ming here on the scramble drill. He would run a big night for him. 14 carries, 86 yards. And then, man, a great catch. Catch of the night. Maybe the catch of the year here for Derek Evans.
Yeah, just a great throw and even better catch. Just an exceptional play. And you know, ran a really good route to get that separation. And then, you know, just pretty special.
5 catches, 178 yards, and 2 touchdowns for Derek. That gave the Bulldogs a 14-10 lead. You get a stop. Here again, your defense playing big. Pass defense this time, Kenny Scott on the other side. Third down is short, and your Bulldogs come up with 2 big plays.
Yeah, I really thought Jagan had a chance to make a play off the edge, and, you know, thought they were going to be possibly going quarterback sneak, and just well executed to be able to stop them.
That's a third and short, and then a fourth and short. And again, Andre Jerpy, the pass defense here, turnover on downs. You're up 14-10. These last 2 minutes are just huge for your offense. It starts Derek Evans again, a stop and go.
Yeah, I had just hit him on a little stick route. You know, this was really just great communication between the two of them, and another good play.
And then Bear gets you in the end zone for 21-10 lead.
Yeah, another little play designed to go inside, made us bounce it, but you know, used his feet to get us an end zone.
Bears' first touchdown as a Wiley Bulldog gave the Bulldogs a 21-10 lead. First half not done, though. Cash Martin gets the interception to set you up for another score before the half.
Yeah, talking about whether or not we should use some timeouts, and it decided to kind of just let it run out if they didn't get the first, and then all of a sudden we're set up here, you know, close to the 10.
Cash Martin, the interception, the tip drill, and great return inside the Stephenville red zone. One of four takeaways, two consecutive weeks, the Bulldog defense with four takeaways. And, boy, beautiful pass and catch here, Bear to Riley Robinson.
Yeah, offensive staff did a great job designing this play. And, you know, really felt like we had two receivers open. What a great throw just over the linebacker. And good catch by Riley.
So 28-10, that's 2 weeks in a row. Riley's been in the end zone at 28-10 at half. And, Coach, let's talk about, again, those last kind of 2 to 3 minutes. You've got the 14-10 lead, and you're able to put a drive together. You score right there, less than 2 minutes to go. 21-10 feels good, but before you know it, that thing explodes to 28-10. Take me through the last 2-3 minutes.
Yeah, you know, we've always talked about it, the last few minutes of the first half, first few minutes of the second half. And it really felt like putting together that drive to go up. We'd done a great job of, you know, just obviously Stephenville had the ball, and, you know, it was third down. Thought maybe we would call a timeout if they ran it, you know, and got the big interception. And what a great way to finish off the first half.
And 28-10, and as you go in, you got an 18-point lead, but let's not make no mistake, and the film from the week before would show it, Stephenville's offense is explosive. They were down by 21 to Decatur the week before. So you've got the 18-point lead. You're getting the ball to start the second half, but how do you keep a group of teenagers together and say, okay, boys, we've played a good first half, we got a second half to go?
Yeah, obviously that's the challenge.
Right.
You know, our guys have great perspective, and I thought they did a great job. But, you know, they scored 28 points in the fourth quarter last week, and, you know, are very well coached and knew they would come back fighting, and sure enough, they did.
So 28-10, it would get interesting there in the second half, but it was an enjoyable final 24 minutes of football as well. We'll show you those second half highlights after our first timeout. We'll also dive into the other sports that are going on here at Wylie High School. We'll get you ready for the San Angelo Central Bobcats as well, homecoming 2023 for the Wylie Bulldogs on Fridays. We take our first timeout. This is the Wylie Bulldog Sports Zone. More to come. Stay tuned.
At Borland Soben and Partners, we're in our third decade of providing high-quality, affordable dental care in Abilene and the Big Country. Our family-friendly clinic offers comprehensive dental care for adults and children. Anything from hygiene and preventative care to cosmetic dentistry and dental implants. And don't worry, we do emergency services too. Our team of professionals understands the latest dental techniques and technology and welcome your questions as we develop the perfect treatment plan for you. And best of all, we offer same-day appointments if you're in pain. So schedule your appointment today, and we'll see you soon.
When it comes to finding the right vehicle for you, there's no better place than Lawrence Hall in Abilene. For over 34 years, Lawrence Hall in Abilene has been the place to find the best from Chevrolet, Buick, and GMC. And that is still true today. Great products and great service, too. So the next time you need a new car, truck, or SUV, come see us or shop 24/7 at LawrenceHallAbileneOnline.com. Voted Abilene's best new car dealer for over 28 years by you, our customers.
At Taylor Electric Cooperative, we are more than just the services we provide. For generations, we have been the link that has connected members to our local community. From those who remember when the lights were first turned on to those who rely daily on our high-speed fiber internet, we are here to make certain that those connections never dim. Because we understand that the most important connection we will ever make is the one we make together. At Taylor Electric, we have provided generations with services for living and connections for life.
Welcome you back into the Wylie Bulldog Sports Zone. We're talking Wylie Bulldog Athletics with the head coach, athletic director of Wylie ISD, Coach Clay Martin. Before we jump into the second half of highlights versus Stephenville, let's say thanks to our great sponsors of the Wylie Bulldog Sports Zone. It starts with Taylor Electric Cooperative, neighbors working for neighbors, our good friends at Taylor Electric Cooperative. Lawrence Hall Chevrolet, recognized by the Abilene Reporter News for more than 20 years as Abilene's best new car dealer. That's Lawrence Hall Chevrolet. Borland Soben and Partners Dentistry, cosmetic and family dentistry, providing the best care possible. You can find them online at bspdentistry.com. And, of course, the Shed Market, 7925 Buffalo Gap Road, the best barbecue in Abilene, Texas. Taking care of our Wylie Bulldogs. They feed us breakfast on Friday mornings on game days as well, our good friends over at the Shed Market. And Abilene Glass and Mirror, you'll hear from them here in just a moment. Abilene Glass and Mirror, our player of the game since 1946, been providing Abilene with glass and mirror. You're sure to find what you're looking for there at AbileneGlass.com. Okay, Coach, 28-10 at half. You had a great first half of play, especially there in the last few minutes. You stretched out, well, really 21 unanswered as you trailed 10-7 there in the second, 21 unanswered. You start on defense as Stephenville won the toss, deferred to the second half, so they get the ball to start the second half. And before we dive in, I just think it was impressive. Last week, Lubbock Cooper, you had the four takeaways that led, you know, three defensive touchdowns, so 21 points off of those. Same thing this week. We'll see some of those turnovers, three of these coming up in the second half. But two consecutive weeks now, your defense has had four takeaways. How huge is that when you look at the course of a game, 48 minutes?
Yeah, I mean, you know, our defense has been very opportunistic, I think is the best way to put it. When we've had chances to make plays, we've made them. They just haven't been tip balls or broken up passes. They've been interceptions and, you know, and scooping scores on fumbles. And so just a very opportunistic defense, I think, that is playing really fast right now.
And so the Bulldogs, again, four takeaways. You're about to see one of those. Again, Coach, we start this second half. You're up 28-10. You start on defense, and Andre Jerpy gets an interception. Second week in a row, he's had one.
Yeah, threw it into some traffic, had a guy there, and obviously tip ball, and just a great play to catch it.
Right on the sideline. Again, Andre's second interception of the year sets the Bulldogs up. Malachi Daniels, another big night, big tough run for Malachi, as Malachi had 25 carries, 98 yards, two touchdowns. And this is a great play here, Bear to Gage Heighton.
Yeah, just great protection by the line. Cameron Vann had a huge block on that run before, and then great protection here, and had a little scheme we thought would work, and you know, executed.
Malachi and the Wildcat get you into the end zone. First of two touchdowns on the night. Well, you're sitting at 35-10 here a few minutes into the third quarter.
Yeah, you know, obviously to hold them and then go down and score was a great job to get some cushion there.
Stephenville starts to make a push, get back in this thing. You get a break on a special teams. Again, here's the third of your four takeaways on the night.
Yeah, I had a little trouble executing offensively for a few series. And, you know, Brady Clark just makes an incredible play to catch the snap and get the punt off. And then, you know, we're pretty fortunate to get a ball, get the ball back there.
Seth Strange, a recovery. It's 35-32. Stephenville makes a comeback. 5:50 left on the clock, and your offense goes to work, milks the clock, and they get points on the board. Bear starts with a great scramble here. As again, Bear, 14 carries, 86 yards. And then a big-time third-down conversion here to Hunter Hood.
Yeah, just a huge drive. You know, obviously the scramble and then this play to keep the drive alive in a clutch situation. Great concentration on the tip ball by Hunter.
So Hunter, three catches, 15 yards on the night. Bear, another quarterback draw as you're, again, milking clock, field position here. And then big play here at the 20-yard line. Malachi's second touchdown on the night.
Yeah, just a little gap is all you need. Malachi is able to explode through the hole. And, you know, coming back from an injury, I thought Malachi had a big night. And, you know, a pretty good job by the offensive line, obviously. Well,
boy, just a little hole to get through. That's all Malachi needed. 42-32, desperation here for the Yellow Jackets. Here's the fourth of your four takeaways. Jake Beard and the interception to seal the victory.
Yeah, what a great catch. You know, a ball thrown deep and overthrown in the back of the end zone, but a great play by Jake to turn and go lay out, make a catch.
As the Bulldogs seal the victory, 42-32, their final score. The Bulldogs get that win. So, Coach, I'm going to put you on the spot because Malachi's last touchdown there, you had a chance to run out the clock, but Malachi went ahead and took it in the end zone. What were your thoughts there?
Yeah, no, I don't know. You know, obviously everybody wants to score.
Right.
Looks a lot better on the deal winning 42-32.
Right.
I was screaming to get out. I will say that. I just soon snapped it in victory.
Yeah, just had a chance to hang on to it, run out the clock. But he gets the touchdown. Defense comes through for you one more time, 42-32. Coach, you know, your offense, we talked about the defense, the four stops. Boy, your offense just looks really good. I know it always starts with the run, but, you know, and the run was great with Malachi right at 100, Bear Ming almost at 100, rushing the football, and then you get six receivers in the mix as Bear goes 12 of 18 on the night.
Yeah, I thought we were better offensively, you know, working on some consistency right now. And, you know, we had some really good drives and then some that kind of sputtered. And, you know, I think that's how it goes this time of year. And so we've just got to continue to improve in that area.
As the Bulldogs just really moved the football well, put 42 points on the board. That speaks for itself. As we do want to mention our Abilene Glass and Mirror player of the game. Of course, on nights like this, when you have four takeaways and 42 offensive points on the board, there's plenty of options, and we do want to celebrate a team victory, so know that. But we do want to give an Abilene Glass and Mirror player of the game, and we thought your junior quarterback, Bear Ming, just the way he executed the offense, again, 12 of 18, 251 yards. That's plus 20 yards per completion on the night, three touchdown passes on the night as well. And then he rushed the ball 14 times for 86 yards, a new dynamic that we hadn't seen much with Bear yet, just running the football. And boy, just a great dual threat for you. And he played really well the other night.
Yeah, I think he's coming into his own in the offense. And, you know, things are slowing down for him. Yep. And, you know, just a very talented, not only with his arm, but also with his legs. And, you know, had a great night, made some really good decisions and some really good throws.
And talk about, again, the offense. We've talked about building blocks, but especially offensively, when you're talking timing of routes and, you know, some combination type stuff. And it just takes time, just takes repetition, and the offense really coming together.
Yeah, no question. It takes some time, and it takes some cohesiveness. I think it takes a lot of belief in each other, mm-hmm. and understanding that the guy's going to be in the right spot. Yep. Execute the plays, and I think that's what we're building.
Okay. It's come a long way. That offense looks good. Defense does too. Bear Ming does get our Abilene Glass and Mirror player of the game this week. Again, 12 of 18, 251 yards passing, the three touchdowns, also 14 carries for 86 yards, and his first touchdown as a Bulldog as well for Bear Ming. Since 1946, Abilene Glass and Mirror has been Abilene's preferred glass and mirror shop. You're sure to find what you're looking for there. You can visit them online at Abilene Glass.com. Coach, a few other notes that I had. Your offensive line, you had some depth in your offensive line. I saw Bryce Brozovic got a lot of playing time up there. And boy, that unit is really starting to gel as well, and a little bit of depth there too.
Yeah, no, got to play some other people. Yep. You know, Aiden Ortega, unfortunately, turned ankle. I don't think it's going to be very long that it'll be out. But, you know, Bryce played a lot, did a good job. Isaiah Valero came in, did a good job. You know, and so – but we've got a few other guys that'll get to play. Marcus Sines came in and played some series, and building a little depth on the offensive line for sure.
So Bulldogs again win 42-32, a 2-0 record on the road, back-to-back wins versus Lubbock Cooper and Stephenville. They get to return home for homecoming 2023 against San Angelo Central this Friday. We'll step aside, then we'll jump into that game with the Bobcats and the Bulldogs coming up on Friday. We'll also look in at the other sports going on here at Wiley, too. Glad you're with us today. This is the Wiley Bulldog Sports Zone. We step aside. More to come. Stay tuned.
At Taylor Electric Cooperative, we are more than just the services we provide. For generations, we have been the link that has connected members to our local community. From those who remember when the lights were first turned on to those who rely daily on our high-speed fiber internet, we are here to make certain that those connections never dim. Because we understand that the most important connection we will ever make is the one we make together. At Taylor Electric, we have provided generations with services for living and connections for life.
When it comes to finding the right vehicle for you, there's no better place than Lawrence Hall in Abilene. For over 34 years, Lawrence Hall in Abilene has been the place to find the best from Chevrolet, Buick, and GMC. And that is still true today. Great products and great service, too. So the next time you need a new car, truck, or SUV, come see us or shop 24/7 at LawrenceHallAbileneOnline.com. Voted Abilene's best new car dealer for over 28 years by you, our customers.
At Borland Soben & Partners, we're in our third decade of providing high-quality, affordable dental care in Abilene and the Big Country. Our family-friendly clinic offers comprehensive dental care for adults and children. Anything from hygiene and preventative care to cosmetic dentistry and dental implants. And don't worry, we do emergency services too. Our team of professionals understands the latest dental techniques and technology and welcome your questions as we develop the perfect treatment plan for you. And best of all, we offer same-day appointments if you're in pain. So schedule your appointment today, and we'll see you soon.
Welcome you back in one final time. The Wiley Bulldog Sports Zone getting you ready for homecoming 2023 this coming Friday. Andy Penny along with the head coach, Coach Clay Martin. Before we do that, let's look in at the other sports going on here at Wiley High School. We start with the volleyball team. They are off to a nice start in district play. They're 2-0 in district play after beating Abilene High. They then beat Abilene Cooper this past Friday in three straight sets. So they are 2-0 in district play. Two big matches this week. It starts on Tuesday nights here at home. They play Monterey. And then they also play at home on Saturday afternoon, a Saturday special versus Lubbock High. Lubbock High gracious enough to move the schedule with homecoming on Friday. That was scheduled for Friday. Lubbock High good to move that to Saturday. So Saturday afternoon at noon, the volleyball team will play host to Lubbock High here at Wiley High School. Cross country will make the trip to Lubbock. They're in the Lubbock Invitational on Saturday. So best of luck to cross country as they travel up to Lubbock. Also, tennis will be in Lubbock on Saturday. Tennis, a tough loss to Lubbock High this past weekend. They fell 11-8 in that team tennis match, 11 matches to 8. But back in Lubbock versus Lubbock Cooper, again, that on Saturday morning up in Lubbock. Boys golf will be in Glen Rose this weekend for the Dinosaur Invitational, one of the better names of a golf tournament, the Dinosaur Invitational. Girls golf has the weekend off. Dinosaur Invitational, one of the better names you've heard?
I have not heard that before.
I guess there's dinosaur track. I think there's dinosaur tracks over there in Glen Rose. So, so they're playing off of that. So a good one, and best of luck to them as well. Okay, Coach, it's homecoming 2023. First of all, favorite homecoming tradition. You've been around a lot of these things. Do you have one? Or is it just, just a whole lot more festivities around a football game?
Yeah, I don't know. I think we take such pride in homecoming.
Yeah.
The tradition of our school and athletic program. And, homecoming's always a special week. There's a lot of things that I remember that have stayed the same for 30 years. Yeah. And, pretty much stay the same again this year.
There are a lot of festivities on the calendar. I know we'll have a homecoming pep rally on Friday afternoon. I know, of course, the crowning of a homecoming queen will put some new faces in the Wiley Hall of Honor. So a lot of festivities that will take place this weekend. For you, though, there's still 48 minutes to be played on the field, and you get to kind of make sure your players are ready. We got to get through all of the fun festivities and still play a football game.
We're going to play a football game one way or another. You just got to keep that in perspective. And at some point at around 7 o'clock, it'll be about us. And, I think that's important that you kind of keep that as week that you continue to build and are prepared to play.
And let's talk X's and O's. San Angelo Central comes to town. First time the Bobcats and the Bulldogs will play here in Abilene. Of course, one for the ages last year, one that the Bulldogs fell short on the final play of the game. Central will make the return trip here to Abilene. First time you've hosted a Class 6A program here. And again, I think that's just talk of continuing to build a program. As now we're in, I believe, year 6 of Class 5A, and these are the type of things you do to continue to build your program. You bring in a quality opponent like San Angelo Central.
Yeah, they'll be a very good opponent, very explosive offensively. Yeah. Obviously have a lot of kids in the school and will have a big program, very well coached, and be a big challenge for us.
Tell us a little bit, X's and O's, about what we might see from the Bobcats, what they do offensively, and what we'll see defensively.
Yeah, they put a lot of pressure on you on the offensive side of the ball. They really can throw the ball well and want to throw the ball, spread the field a lot, but are effective in the run game. And have been a high-powered offense for several years now, and this year's no different.
Okay, so I believe Central comes in 1-3 on the year. Of course, the Bulldogs are 2-2. We touched on it again. Building blocks, I guess, has kind of been my catchphrase during this show. This is your last chance before district play. An open date next week before Plainview 2 weeks from now. So as you look 4 weeks in, what are you proud of that you've accomplished? And maybe a few final things you'd like to see as district play gets on the horizon.
Yeah, proud of the team we're building.
Yep.
Proud of the progress that we've made, the maturity that I think has been apparent so far. And proud of the way in which the guys have come to work each and every week. And, we've had some adversity and had to deal with it. We're a long way from where we want to be, and that's a good thing. We've got a lot of things to work on and execute, and I think we'll continue to get better.
Well, there you go. And then the final question that always comes your way, some keys to victory, some keys to success for your Bulldogs to try to push this to a 3-game winning streak as you close out non-district.
Yeah, we've got to be able to continue to play fast on the defensive side of the ball. you know, they're going to, it's going to be pretty easy with them throwing it all over the yard. They kind of set on your heels, and we've got to be aggressive and play fast. And we've got to figure out a way to limit explosive plays. You know, kind of was the Achilles heel the other night. You know, that's kind of a goal of ours this week for sure. You know, on the offensive side of the football, it's all comes down to execution. Yeah. I really believe that. We've got to continue to establish a run game, and that'll be a big emphasis for us.
Well, there you go. It'll just be fun to be back on the field for these guys, and especially let's eliminate a couple miles on the car, and let's just play at home this week. What do you think?
Yeah, that'll be good. Homecoming is a special week, and so it'll be a big week for us and a big game.
You bet. So, well, Coach, we appreciate everything. Looking forward to Friday night. Let's keep them rolling. Best of luck on Friday, and we'll talk to you down the road.
Hey, thank you.
There you go. As, again, the Bulldogs play host to San Angelo Central Homecoming 2023. It's a 7 o'clock kickoff here from Hugh Sandifer Stadium. Plenty of pregame festivities going on. They'll start as early as 6 o'clock. The introduction of the players, the student managers, the trainers, the cheerleaders. We'll have all that during the pregame. Of course, the Homecoming Queen ceremony at halftime, the Hall of Honor recognition at halftime. The bands will play at halftime. There'll be 48 minutes of football on the field as well. San Angelo Central and Wiley, 7 o'clock kickoff. And, of course, you can see the live stream of it on Wiley Bulldog Productions on YouTube as well. So we will talk to you down the road. And pay a special thanks to all of our great sponsors, Taylor Electric Cooperative, Borland Soap and Partners Dentistry, Lawrence Hall Chevrolet, The Shed Market, and Abilene Glass and Mirror. Bobcats and Bulldogs Friday night. Until then, have a great week. Go Bulldogs. So long, everybody.
Watching a Wiley Bulldog Productions broadcast.
Friday Night Lights come alive under the West Texas sunset. Wiley Bulldog Football. Featuring the Wiley Pure Gold Band. Keeping you clued in on the hottest gridiron action around. Andy Penny and Ryan Holmes. And the main attraction, your Wiley Bulldogs under the leadership of head coach Clay Martin. Right now on 106.3 The Raider, this is Wiley Bulldog Football.
Homecoming 2023. Welcome in, folks. It is a beautiful sight here. It's still hot. It's the last non-district game of the schedule, but it is Wiley Bulldog football in front of a great home crowd here at Hugh Sandifer Stadium. It's the Wiley Bulldogs at 2-2, playing host to the San Angelo Central Bobcats at 1-3. How are you, Bulldog Nation? Happy homecoming again, 2023. It's Wiley ISD, Wiley Bulldog Productions on YouTube and 106.3 The Raider. Glad to bring you Wiley Bulldog football. I'm Andy Penny, your play-by-play voice tonight for what should be a good one. If you'll remember back 365 or so days ago, it was a game that came down to the final play in the first ever meeting between Central and Wiley, a game that Central won 63-61. We hope the outcome is certainly different tonight. It should be a fun one, but at the end of the night, it's purple and gold versus blue and orange and a competitive night of Texas high school football. We'll get you ready between now and the top of the hour in the kickoff tonight for homecoming 2023. Always glad to be joined by my good friends. My first one to the right, my right-hand side. That is the biggest garter I've ever seen, but it looks good on your right arm. My good friend, the Hodge, Ryan Holmes. Hodge, welcome into Wiley Bulldog football, my friend.
Man, it's good to be back in the Hugh and back here on another Friday night. And again, as you mentioned, the final preparation game to get us ready for district. We got a bye next week, which a lot of the 16 districts across the state will be experiencing that bye next week, open week. And so looking forward to being out here again. Homecoming, a lot of purple and gold, a lot of stories, I'm sure, being reminisced back when you remember we played on grass and all those sorts of things, and things were tougher when we played in 2004 or 1999 or whatever. And so Hall of Honor, ring, all the excitement that comes with homecoming, and I'll be part of my keys to victory a little bit later on, but it's good to be here tonight.
Well, let's talk about these Bulldogs that we've had the chance to see for the last 4 weeks, but let's really hone in on the last 2 weeks. A win in Lubbock versus Lubbock Cooper, 35-34. And in a very impressive showing last Friday night in Stephenville, 42-32 against the Stephenville Yellow Jackets. Man, what a great night of football for the Bulldogs. And here we are at 2-2 in game number 5.
Well, and those two wins had different things about them that made them interesting and fun. One was the three defensive touchdowns in the first half against Lubbock Cooper. And then last week we got out to a big jump, a big lead against Stephenville, looking really good. Again, Bear Ming looking comfortable, over 300 yards of offense last week. But then we almost had to get answer. We had to get ready because Stephenville started to punch back, had two big plays, 73 and I believe 68 yards, touchdown passes, but got back into it and made us have to answer a little bit. We could have easily, they got us on the ropes, and then we were able to get a stop, big third down conversion from Ming to Hood to extend the drive, and then was able to get that 10-point lead.
So the Bulldogs bring in the two-game winning streak here. They are now 2-2 on the year, trying to make it a three-game winning streak here to close it out. It's homecoming 23. It's nice and hot out here. It's supposed to, the temperature is supposed to start dropping, but it's not yet, and Dustin Tatro will be fighting that all night long. He's down on the field, the third member of our team. Dustin, welcome to Wiley Bulldog football, my friend.
Oh, man, it feels good to be back here at the U. We're in the shade, and the stands are bursting at the seams. Nobody bought me a garter, man. What's up with that?
We'll work on that. My apologies.
Next year's budget will be bigger.
There we go.
Well, Dustin, you've had a good chance field level to watch this Bulldog team the last 2 weeks. Your thoughts on what we've seen from the purple and gold?
I have. We've got to keep that great offense running. We're starting to really get some synergy with Bear and Derek and the gang. But I was looking at stats this week. Two straight losses for San Angelo, as I mentioned on middays today. But over 350 yards in the air for their quarterback. So we got to make sure we don't ever let him get those long passes in tonight. The defense is still going to be the key to victory for me.
Great segue there, Dustin. I love it. It's a Central offense. Yeah, 1-3. On the record sheet, but an offense that averages 36.3 points a game. They can get up and down the field. They like to go vertical. They like to throw the deep ball, make a play, and break a tackle and score some touchdowns. They put a lot of points on the board, and that'll be a great matchup between offense, the Central offense, and this Wiley defense, who's turned in 8 takeaways in the last 2 weeks.
Well, and it's going to be important. And some of those that are going to be key are those secondary guys. We've seen Jerpy playing well. We got Hayden Wright back off the being injured a couple weeks ago. He's back in the lineup. Cash Martin. But again, secondary guys are going to have to take care of their assignment, knowing where they need to be so that we don't give up those big plays, because that's what really kept Stephenville in the game last week, were the two big touchdown passes they had.
The Bulldogs built a 35-10 lead. Stephenville Came all the way back, made it 35-32. But then a late touchdown by the Bulldogs sealed it, 42-32, the final score last week. You see the captains making their way out onto the field. We'll have the coin toss take place here in just a moment. Dustin Tatro will join him as part of that coin toss as well.
You think about it, 365 days ago, how wild that game was. You know, we've mentioned it. We've been doing this literally. You're a lot better at math than I am, but not a whole lot of games, a whole season and four games in, and the excitement that we've been able to call. And when, again, we can't thank you guys that are watching at your home, watching some, maybe at a restaurant or wherever. We appreciate y'all tuning in wherever you are tonight. Heck, you may be here in the Hue listening to us. We appreciate you guys.
And the captains are down on the field. Let's send it down to Dustin Tatro. Dustin?
All right. Handshakes going here. We'll get that coin toss ceremony in just a moment.
All right, I have two things, gentlemen. Sportsmanship and stop on the whistle, okay? Have fun, all right? That's the main thing. Have fun. All right. You guys are visitors. You can call it. There's heads. That's tail. It's heads. That's tail. You can call it. Call it loud enough for him to hear.
Tails.
He called tails. It is heads. Wiley, you want to toss.
As you just heard the announcement, Wiley has won the coin toss, has deferred to the second half, and they'll be kicking to the north tonight.
All right, so it will be the Bulldog defense on the field again. 8 takeaways in the last 2 weeks, and they have been playing really, really well. And it should be fun. And Dustin, you kind of keyed on it. That's kind of one of your keys to victory tonight, right? That Bulldog defense?
Absolutely. Just not ever let that quarterback get it in the air.
So the Bulldogs deferred to the second half. San Angelo Central will get the football first, and we'll move from south to north. We pause here for the national anthem. Tonight we are going to be joined by the Wiley High School Show Choir here on the track. They will be singing the national anthem for us. As we look forward to hearing that again here on Homecoming 2023, and a great crowd that has come in here tonight for our game.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we hold were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the and the home of the brave.
The song that never gets old, our Stars and Stripes, our national anthem. We say thank you to all of those involved who protect our freedom both here in the United States and worldwide, our United States military. Thank you for all you do in support of us. All right, Hodge, let's talk a little Wiley Bulldog football here. Always like to come to you this part of the game and this part of the pregame. Get your keys to victory tonight for the Wiley Bulldogs.
So the keys to victory, number one, it is homecoming. You got to block out the extra. When there's a homecoming, A lot of things happen. You got to block out the extracurricular and just play football. The other is win the line of scrimmage. You got to win the line of scrimmage. Give yourself an opportunity to create plays, open up the run game, win the line of scrimmage. Number three, no big plays. You heard Dustin talk about it, no big plays. And then finally, San Angelo Central's coming in with a chip on their shoulder. Nobody wants to be scheduled as homecoming. Knock that chip off, having that little Friday night snack with that chip on that shoulder. Those will be the keys to getting the first win here at the Hue.
Just had, I hope you saw on your screen, a four airplane flyover right after the national anthem here on homecoming 2023. Something pretty special here at the Hue. As again, the Bulldogs won the toss, deferred to the second half. We'll see the Central kickoff return team on the field and the Wiley kickoff team on the field to get things underway. Brady Clark, the senior, has it teed up at that south 40-yard line. It is a hot night tonight. As we look at the thermometer, we are in the high 90s. Hopefully this thing will cool off as the night continues. But a breeze coming out of the south. It will be at the Bulldogs' back here in the first quarter. 94 degrees on the thermometer. Bulldogs 2-2, Bobcats 1-3. Here's Brady Clark's kickoff. It's a deep one. It will go out of the back of the end zone. It's a touchback. And that's where the Central Bobcat offense will start their first drive, first and 10 on their own 25-yard line. Christian English is their quarterback. English, a 5'11", 170-pound junior. English last week, 365 yards passing and three touchdowns, 190 yards rushing and two touchdowns. Already two games this year for Christian English with more than 300 yards passing and 100 yards rushing. So he is an impressive one, the junior quarterback in Christian English. Bobcats will start on the left hash. First and 10 again on the 25-yard line. English will start with four receivers in his formation. Tyree Brawley is the running back, offset to his left. Brawley will get the carry off the left side. He's met by the defensive front, led by Jackson Carpenter. The senior defensive tackle will make the first tackle of the night. Brawley picks up three. Second down at seven now here for the Bobcats. And the Bobcats like to throw the football vertically down the field, try to get some one-on-one matchups and make some plays in their pass game. Second down, seven, balls at the 28. As English will get rid of it in a hurry. Quick pass near sideline across the 30 and the 35. First catch of the night for Colton Hill. Hill's got 12 as they'll mark it on the 40-yard line. So one of one start tonight.
Josh Patterson on the tackle there. Again, just a quick little screen. Well, not necessarily screen, just quick pass out to the what Texas Tech calls a run play.
Colton Hill last week, 12 receptions, 178 yards. And a touchdown versus Belton. First and 10 now on the 40-yard line. English, play action, is going to get rid of it in a hurry. Quick square in, caught on the far side across the 50 into Bulldog territory. First catch of the night for Alex Lindsay. Lindsay's got 12, moved the sticks again. And again, we'll see a lot of this tonight. Quick passes, move the sticks. That's what Central likes to do. Again, Jackson Carpenter, your defensive tackle tonight. Seth Strange, Garrett Allison, Larry Smith. You'll hear all three of those names at defensive end. Currently, it's Allison and Smith on the field. First and 10 at the 48. Again, a quick pass. Far side, caught up the field. That's Lindsay, and Lindsay has another first down. He's pushed out at the 34-yard line. 14 more for Lindsay. Every pass thus far, Hodge, has been double-digit yards, moved the sticks for first downs.
Yeah, and Jerpy right there went to try to blow it up, but was blocked really well, which opened up the opportunity for the first down.
So ball on the 34 after that 14-yard pass and catch. First and 10 at the 34 in Wiley territory. Another play action, quick pass, out pattern. This one overthrown and incomplete. And Lindsay, the intended receiver. First incompletion tonight for English. Set the linebackers for Wiley tonight. Colin Bruning, the senior captain, starts at a middle linebacker. Melo Martinez, the junior, also starts at linebacker. Josh Patterson on the outside, as well as Cash Martin. Of course, Cash had the big interception last week versus Stephenville. We'll set the secondary after second down and 10. Ball at the 34. Play action again. Quick out pattern. Caught on the near side this time. Another catch. Alex Lindsay's been the receiver of choice thus far, and it looks like by a spot he'll have enough, and he does, for another Central first down. 10 on this pass and catch.
And again, from the secondary position, you're going to have to be sure, again, take care of your assignment. Don't get fooled by the play action. Pretty much every pass that's been thrown so far has had some type of little quick play action to the fullback or to the running back, and so you got to be sure you pay attention with that. But it looks like we
moved the chains too far. They got it set. 10 yards on the play. Five consecutive passes from this Central offense. First and 10, ball at the Wiley 24-yard line. Straight drop, English looks in the center of the field, caught, flag flies, a quick pass and catch, first catch of the night for Malik Cates, the 5'9 senior, but I'm afraid this one's coming back. Our first Pest Patrol penalty flag tonight will be a holding here on the Central offense. Pest Patrol, family-owned and operated business, number one focus, providing customers with the best pest control services available. That's our good friends at Pest Patrol. So move for the first time, Central behind the sticks here. Set the secondary for you tonight. Kenny Scott to start at cornerback. Andre Jerpy also the start at corner. Hayden Wright is your strong safety, the junior. Jake Bearden, the junior, is your free safety. So first down and 20 now for the Bobcats. They're on the Wiley 34 on the right hash. Take the snap, play action again. Pressure off the edge. English, throw it out. It's incomplete. Pressure off the edge from Cash Martin, the outside linebacker. The pass thrown behind Colton Hill. Incompletion makes it second down at 20.
And I think that's one of the things that we're going to need to see from the defense is pressure on Christian. That way he makes that decision, make it a little bit more difficult. Great job by Cash Martin putting that pressure on.
Just underway tonight, 9:48 left in our opening quarter. This is the opening drive of the night. Second down, 20 for the Central offense. It's on the right hash on the 34. Four receiver set, twins to both sides. Straight drop for English, four-man pressure. Pressure's getting to him. He'll scramble out to the left. Still scrambling, and all he can do is throw it out of bounds. That's a coverage sack with good pressure. Great job by the Bulldogs, all 11. It's third down and 20 for the Central offense.
Yeah, and a great job by the secondary, Josh Cole, Jerpy, staying with their coverage area to allow that thing not to develop and let them find us whole. And again, throws it out of bounds. I think a cheerleader might have caught it for San Angelo Central.
They were open. I saw that. As you mentioned, Josh Cole on the field. This is the nickel package. Five secondary in for the Bulldogs here. Third down and 20. Keep the Bobcats in front. Make a tackle. Force a fourth down. Four receiver set. English take the snap. Shows a little play action. He looks to his left. Now scrambles to his right. Surveys the field. No pressure in his face. Bruning now giving chase. Throw to the center of the field. Caught at the 24. Diving ahead to the 20. Did the ball come out? Yes, it did. And Josh Patterson's on the run with it. Down the near sideline. And the Bulldogs have their first takeaway tonight. As the catch was made by Alex Lindsay. Had the ball popped out from behind. And after eight takeaways the last 2 weeks, the Bulldog defense comes up with their first tonight. First and 10, Wiley. They'll start in their own territory at the 49-yard line.
Yeah, really great job. Again, a lot of time to throw the football. Receiver settled in, got it caught. Great job by the Bulldogs punching it out. Patterson with the recovery. Great job now. First and 10 at their own 49.
They'll start at the 49 under the leadership of the junior quarterback, Bear Ming. First to 10 again on the 49. Malachi Daniels has started running back tonight. He'll get it. The senior off right guard. He's into Central territory in a hurry. Malachi's got six. He's to the Central 45. Bear Ming again, the quarterback, 45 of 73 on the year, 765 yards passing, eight touchdowns. Three last week versus Stephenville. First throw tonight. Derek Evans down the sideline, just overthrown and incomplete. Fade pattern on the near side. Derek had a step, but just overthrown. Third down and four now here for the Bulldogs.
And I really like that he just got a little bit outthrown, but again, they were uptight on Derek. Derek was able to get outside and just a little bit of a delay. A lot of contact up front by the cornerback.
So now third down and four, ball on the 45, Central Territory. They'll try the same play. Evans near sideline. He's got this one in stride. He's down inside the 10. It's first and goal. As Derek brought down, let's see where they mark it. Right on the five. It's 40 on the first catch of the night for Derek Evans. First and goal, Bulldogs, the five-yard line.
And again, there's no reason to not continue to run that play. Derek got by him in the first time. Again, playing up tight on Derek, and then Derek gets by him for a great catch. Now first and goal.
Derek last week, five receptions, 178 yards. That's 35 yards a reception. He's got 40 on his first one tonight. Now here's first and goal at the five. Wildcat, Malachi off the right side. No gain on the play. They marked it on the seven, so we're going to go back. 38 for Derek. First and goal from the seven. Malachi, no gain on first and goal. So now second down and goal from the seven-yard line. Still in that Wildcat. Jaden Smith offset to Malachi's right. Malachi counterplay, trying to come back left. No room to run. That play imploded. It's a loss this time of three. And now third down and goal from the 10. And the regular offense looks like with Bear Ming will come back in. Third down and goal.
Yeah, it kind of makes you wonder what Coach Kincaid's thinking here. Derek back in. Maybe the old fade to the corner of the end zone.
So third and goal from the 10. Ming back in at the quarterback. Take the snap. Straight drop pressure all over coming. He scrambles to his right. Surveys the field. He's got a chance to run. A flag flies. He'll throw to the back of the end zone. It's caught. Hunter Hood out of the end zone on the far side. He made the catch, but incomplete. There's a flag down, too, in the area of holding here on the Bulldogs. Pest Patrol penalty flag. We'll get the white hat. Glenn Bamlett, the white hat official tonight. We'll look to make the call.
You can't do it. You don't want to decline it.
Yeah, it was out of. It was incomplete, so it would be fourth and
goal.
Oh,
it was incomplete. I thought he caught it.
He caught it, but out of bounds. A chop block. So a chop block on the Bulldogs. The penalty is declined. It's fourth down and goal from the 10. Here comes the field goal unit. Brady Clark. Brady's attempted just one field goal on the year. He did it versus Monterey, and he missed from 40. This is a little shorter one as it is at the 17-yard line. It's a 27-yard field goal attempt. Trying to give the Bulldogs the lead here in their opening possession. The snap is back. The kick is on the way, and there's flags on the field. The kick is good. San Angelo Central is offsides. It would be fourth and goal from the five. Do you take points off the board and run an offensive play, or do you take your 3 points?
I don't know. I like the thought they're declining it, is what Bamlett's saying. Keeping the points.
So Brady Clark, good from 27. The Bulldogs score first tonight. 7:34 left in our first quarter. Our score, Wiley 3. San Angelo Central, 0. This is Wiley Bulldog Football. We're powered by Taylor Electric Cooperative from the Wiley Bulldog Sports Network and 106.3 The Raider.
When First Financial Bank opened its doors in 1890, a relationship between a local community bank and a state was born. For more than 130 years, First Financial has grown alongside you, your family, your business, all while putting your goals first. From the ports to the plains. First Financial Bank, we're Texas.
At Taylor Electric Cooperative, we are more than just the services we provide. For generations, we have been the link that has connected members to our local community. From those who remember when the lights were first turned on to those who rely daily on our high-speed fiber internet, we are here to make certain that those connections never dim. Because we understand that the most important connection we will ever make is the one we make together. At Taylor Electric, we have provided generations with services for living and connections for life.
And back here is the return as the kickoff happened in a hurry. The return out across the 25. Alex Lindsay on the return. Bulldogs have a 3-0 lead after the Brady Clark 27-yard field goal. Six plays, 41 yards, a minute 48 off of the clock. It started with the defensive takeaway, a fumble returned by Josh Patterson to the 49, and Bulldogs get down into field goal territory. Third week in a row they played with the lead, Hodge.
Yeah, and again, you're glad to walk away with points. Maybe a little bit of frustration of not getting the touchdown, but putting points on the board, now you need another stop by the defense.
So here is Christian English and company, first and 10 on their own 27. English wants to get rid of it in a hurry. Quick curl pattern, caught on the near side, and dropped right after the catch. First catch of the night by number 18. That's Jimmy Edwards. Josh Patterson, Kenny Scott, both there. Hey, let's go down to the sideline. Our first visit with Dustin Tatro in a sideline report. Dustin?
Right before the interception, it was looking at St. Angelo quarterback English, just looking around like an Abilene driver at a four-way stop. What do I do? We had his receivers covered. We need to keep doing that.
Already 9 pass attempts for English tonight. He's 6 out of 9. He'll hand it off this time. Spun around, short gain. As Brawley had the carry, but met right in the hole. Larry Smith leads the way, 3rd down and 4 after the 1 yard gain.
Yeah, 3rd and very manageable here as a secondary. Jerpy, Stone, all these guys got to make sure that they don't, not Stone, but Scott, make sure you know where the sticks are. Don't let them push you off too far. Know where the sticks are.
At the 33, they need the 37. English straight drop, looks to his right, throw the out, it's overthrown, it's incomplete. He just sailed that one. No pressure in his face. Colton Hill ran an out pattern at 5 yards to get a first down, and English just sailed it over his head. Here come the personnel changes. Looks like a 3-and-out defensive series.
Yeah, that's a great response to the field goal. Again, you get the points on the board, but that's a great response. 3-and-out, one of those things that Coach Cates loves to see. We talk about victory formation being a great formation. 3-and-out is the favorite play for the defense.
Looks like that's Jimmy Edwards to punt the football away, and he will. Check that, it's Colton Farmer who punts it. Fair catch called for by Hunter Hood and made, and the Bulldogs have it back. 6:10 left in our first quarter. Wiley 3, San Angelo Central 0. And Brady Clark, the 27-yard field goal there on the first drive. Bear Ming, 1 of 2 on his opening series. 38-yard connection to Derek Evans. Again, Derek last week. Huge week at Stephenville. 5 catches for 178 yards. 2 touchdowns, and one of the best catches you'll see on the high school level last week for his 2nd touchdown. 1st and 10 at the 37 for Ming and company. He'll take the snap, hand off to Daniels. Tries to get back behind his offensive line. Short gain on the play. He's met by the linebacker, Cohen Orcala. Malachi had a big week last week, too. Just shy of 100 yards rushing, 25 carries, 98 yards, really carried the load. 2nd down and 9 here from the 38. Ming takes a snap, gets rid of it in a hurry. It's Cooper Jones on the far side with blockers in front. 45 has a 1st down. Gave Central a little taste of their own medicine there. And they'll mark it at the 50. It's a 12-yard pass and catch for Cooper Jones and a Wiley Bulldog 1st down.
And it's good when you see a kid come out of nowhere as a senior, start to play a little bit, contribute. Great job by Cooper. And I notice over here, Derek no longer having coverage tight.
Here's quarterback draw, Ming on the right side. And a good open field tackle coming up, making that tackle. Kaysen Rogers. Ming does pick up 2 on the design quarterback draw. Ming had a good week rushing the football last week. He had 86 yards on the ground himself. A totally different dynamic, Hodge. Last week we saw Bear run the football design runs a bunch.
A lot of draws, a lot of putting it in his hands, especially down the stretch of that last drive.
2nd and 8 on the 48. Ming, give it to Daniels. Up the middle, finds a seam. He's in the secondary. He's inside the 35 to the 34. 14 for Malachi. 1st and 10, Bulldogs.
Yeah, great job. Good job by the umpire becoming an extra blocker there. Good job by Malachi using him.
Bulldogs will go up tempo here on 1st and 10. Ming, get rid of it in a hurry. It's Jones on the near side this time. Loses his footing as he tries to change directions. Forward progress will stop him. His helmet pops off as well. Short gain on the forward progress. And they'll give him 2 on that pass and catch. And I don't think, maybe 1 catch on the year for Cooper. Coming out. Cooper had 1 catch on the year. He's got 2 here in the first quarter. 2nd down and 8, ball at the Central 32. On the left hash, trips to the right. Ming take the snap. Quarterback draw again, coming left. He's got the 30. He's got the 25. He's close to a first down. I think he's got it. And he does at the 23. 9 for Bear Ming.
And when you have that, Andy, to be able to have that in your arsenal, knowing that, hey, I've got to know where that quarterback is. I've got to know where Ming is because he is dangerous to run. And a great job by the offensive line creating that opportunity in an alley for him to go down.
First and 10 at the 23. Take the snap. It's Malachi. Met in the hole. Nowhere to go. He'll lose one on this play. Good pursuit on the front line this time. The tackle made by Courtney Madrano. Second down, 11.
Yeah, and that's where it's a frustration right there from an offensive line standpoint when you, as soon as you get the ball, you're getting contact in the backfield. Not good.
You've heard Malachi's name at the running back. Your receiving core tonight, of course, Derek Evans, Riley Robinson, Hunter Hood. Seth Strange is in at the H-back. He and Brendan Underwood will trade that position out tonight. Second and 11 at the 24. Play action. Center of the field. Wide open receiver. It's Riley Robinson. He will backpedal into the end zone. It's a Wiley Bulldog touchdown. And for the third week in a row, Riley Robinson in the end zone. It's 9-0 Bulldogs with an extra point to come. Great play design. The play action held the linebackers, and Riley ran right by them. Bulldogs, two offensive drives tonight, two scores. 9-0, PAT on the way. Brady Clark in to kick that extra point. Isaiah Valero, your snapper. Drew Penny's the holder. Snap is back. Brady's kick is on the way. It is good. 3:27 left. First quarter, our score, Wiley 10, Central 0. Bulldog football powered by Taylor Electric Cooperative on the Wiley Bulldog Sports Network, 106.3, the Raider.
When selling your home, you could take all the photos yourself. But if you have a RE/MAX agent,
guys, how are you?
They know a team of experts who will get the job done right.
At Borland Soben & Partners, we're in our third decade of providing high-quality, affordable dental care in Abilene and the Big Country. Our family-friendly clinic offers comprehensive dental care for adults and children. Anything from hygiene and preventative care to cosmetic dentistry and dental implants. And don't worry, we do emergency services too. Our team of professionals understands the latest dental techniques and technology and welcome your questions as we develop the perfect treatment plan for you. And best of all, we offer same-day appointments if you're in pain. So schedule your appointment today, and we'll see you soon.
Riley Robinson, his third touchdown reception of the year. He's giving the Bulldogs a 10-0 lead. Bear Ming, 4 of 5 out of the chute, 76 yards and the touchdown as well. Good start here, Hodge.
Oh, yeah, great job again, being able to set up the play action with the run. Good job by Ming on being able to run a little bit with the draw. And again, Robinson wide open and a little homecoming dance into the end zone.
There is Brady's kick. That's a deep kick as well. It will hit on the goal line into the end zone. It is a touchback. Hey, let's get out on the field. Let's visit with our good friend, Dustin Tatro. Dustin, what do you think down there, man?
You know, on the offensive drive, seeing the Bulldogs making some great use of some mixed tactics last week, Bears starting to do some rushing plays, and we're seeing that again tonight. I think it's a good sign.
Now Central plays from behind. Of course, they like to pass the football anyway.
Right.
But you can certainly start teeing up and looking for some play calls here that will lean the way of the pass.
And you wonder if they start to look to go down the field, or maybe they're waiting for that half to change and get the win behind them.
Yeah.
But they really have kind of just, as you mentioned, ran a lot of short pass plays.
First and 10 on the 25. They'll put it on the left hash to start. English, straight drop. He'll throw a fade pattern. Overthrown and incomplete. Andre Jerpy there in coverage. Believe that was Colton Hill, the intended receiver, far side. Already 11 passes here in the quarter for English. He's 6 of 11, 67 yards. But that's now, I believe, 4 incompletions in a row. After the fumble on the opening drive, I believe that's 4 incompletions now in a row.
Yeah, and that first part of this first quarter started going pretty quick because they were completing everything. Now you're starting to see the clock stop because of the incomplete passes.
Second and 10, straight drop again, English. Three-man pressure, good pocket. He'll tuck it and run this time. He's got the 30, spins around to about the 34. Had a good pocket, but nothing open down the field. English just says, I'll do it myself. First carry of the night. And again, 2 weeks already this year, English has had 300 yards passing and 100 yards rushing. So he's a dual threat. He's got 9 there. It's third down and 1. 2:57 left in our opening quarter. It's Wiley 10, Central 0.
If they've watched film, which you know they've had, watch the hard count. We've been tendencies to pull.
Bali will get it on the left side. He's got a first down. He'll fall forward to the 40-yard line on the short gain. Hayden Wright, the junior, makes a tackle. It is 6 for Bali and move the sticks. You know, we're about 35 points behind pace where we were last year at San Angelo. You remember that?
Yeah. We were their homecoming last year, too, I think.
Man alive. First to 10 on the 40. Ball on the left hash. English straight drop. Three-man pressure. Pressure's getting to him. Larry Smith Jr. misses him. Throw up the sideline. Overthrown and incomplete. It's again pressure. Larry Smith has got his chin up in the air, frustrated with himself. But because of the pressure, it disrupts the play and the pass sails. It's second down at 10.
And the little things that matter, I believe it's Hayden Wright. The ball gets overthrown, and he knew to slow up and not hit the defenseless receiver. So great job there as well, doing the little things right.
Second and 10 on the 40 for receiver set. English with pressure off the edge. Throws the out pattern. Caught. That's Bali out of the backfield, who will fall forward to the 44. Four-yard gain. Josh Cole out of the secondary. Getting a lot of nickel tonight. Five secondary, and Cole makes that play. It's third down to 6.
And again, this is another thing that the Wiley Bulldog defense is really trying to hang their hat on, is get that third down, get them out of the field, get their punt team on onto the field. And so we'll see what happens here. Third and very manageable.
Third and 6 at the Central 44. English straight drop, pressure coming. Good pocket. He'll scramble out to his left. He'll run for the first down, far sideline. He's got Wiley territory, and he runs out of bounds at about the 40-yard line. Again, that's where you have to keep contained. 14 on the carry for English, first down and 10.
And again, when the receivers take the secondary away from the line of scrimmage and take them down the field, it allows English to have a lot of running room and a lot of grass or turf, you will, to pick up the first down.
Central back into Wiley territory. They were down inside the 35 on their opening drive. They're at the 42 here. English roll the pocket this time to the right. Still surveying the field. Throw it back center of the field. Nice leaping catch at the 30-yard line. Colton Hill, another grab. Tackled immediately by Josh Cole, but it's 11 more for Hill, his second catch tonight. This is what Central does. As English has 7 completions tonight, 6 of them are 10 or more yards. So
that helps you get to that 300-yard passing night pretty quick.
He's at 78 already on 7 of 13 passing. First and 10 at the 31. Motion across the formation this time, trips to the left. English, center of the field, knocked away and incomplete. Josh Cole was there. Alex Lindsay, the intended receiver, flooded the field to the left that time, and pass just falls incomplete, second down at 10.
You know, really, when English goes to throw the football, and it almost, he doesn't get rid of it real quickly.
Yep.
And so it almost has a little bit of a floater. Yep. So he may see another Cash Martin interception, or maybe one for Hayden Wright.
Okay, we're going to put you on the spot there. Tight end to the right here in this formation. English going to tuck it and run. Sidesteps a defender. He's inside the 25, close to another first down at the 22. Looks like just short. And again, that's just contained there by the Bulldogs. And, man, give English credit. He's elusive. He's got 9. It's third down and 1.
Jerpy's asking for a little bit of help over there, being held. I think he's asking a little bit of Pest Patrol penalty flag to pop out. Easy for me to say.
Third down and 1. Ball is on the Wiley 22. Brawley offset to English's right. Take the snap. Brawley will get the handoff going left. He's dropped in the backfield. Loses yardage back to the 25. Colin Bruning, Melo Martinez, Larry Smith Jr. all there. It's fourth down. It's decision time. They'll have a quarter to think about it as we are at the end of the first quarter. Our score, Wiley 10, Central 0. Big fourth down coming up as we start the second quarter. Bulldog football powered by Taylor Electric Cooperative, the Wiley Sports Network, and 106.3 The Raider.
When it comes to finding the right vehicle for you, there's no better place than Lawrence Hall in Abilene. For over 34 years, Lawrence Hall in Abilene has been the place to find the best from Chevrolet, Buick, and GMC. And that is still true today. Great products and great service, too. So the next time you need a new car, truck, or SUV, come see us or shop 24/7 at LawrenceHallAbileneOnline.com. Voted Abilene's best new car dealer for over 28 years by you, our customers.
Nothing Bulldogs. We get ready to start the second quarter. Andy Penny alongside Ryan Holmes, the Hodge. Dustin Tatro down on the sideline as well. Decision time here, Hodge. Fourth down and about four for the Central offense.
Well, I would almost think you want to, I mean, fourth and four, I think you go ahead and find a way to go for it. If I'm Coach Crane, I feel confident to go for it, even though you haven't really stopped them. But right now, something really good happened during the break.
Yeah, so the ball should be on the 25, fourth and four. The ball is sitting at the 35. So there we go. Okay.
Coach Martin wasn't going to say anything, I can assure you. Coach Crane was like, need a little help here. And so fourth down and four. English looking over to the side to try to get the play in, and offense is staying on the field.
Bobcats will go fourth and four from the Wiley 25. Four receiver set, twins to both sides. Brawley offset, quick curl pattern. Oh, knocked away, incomplete. Andre Jerpy, the junior. Jerpy a little chirpy too, but it doesn't matter. It's a turnover on downs. Bulldogs had the football.
Yeah, and right there, got a little excited there, did Josh Patterson. Got a little excited. Great job understanding the official composure, understanding the competitiveness of what happens in a game like this. Very fortunate, no flag there, but a great job by Coach Cates and his defense, and now Bear Ming an opportunity to take him down and add on to this 10-0 lead.
First to 10 here, Bulldogs on the 25. So we've had a takeaway, a three-and-out series, and a fourth down turnover on downs at your own 25 for the Bulldog defense. Here's first to 10 for the offense. Melo Martinez, check that Jaden Lucero in the backfield. His first carry tonight, he's across the 30 to about the 34. Lucero, the 5'8 junior, has got 9 on his first carry tonight. Yeah, depth at the running back spot. Good run by Jade.
Yeah, great job by Lucero. After Juju went down, Malachi went down. He got some great reps early. Been a really good asset for us.
Here's second and one. Quick pass. Evans near side. He's got it at the 50. He's into central territory down inside the 40-yard line. 28 more for the senior, Derek Evans. It's a Bulldog first and 10.
I think Derek was a little shocked on how open he was on that. And, again, great job moving the ball. Coach Kincaid in the offense.
Wiley went up-tempo. I don't think Central's defense was set. Derek was wide open. There's a handoff again up the middle. Lucero, he's inside the 35, about the 34. There's four more for Jaden. Have not had a chance. Well, let's check this flag first. A pest patrol penalty flag on the field. Jaden had four. We'll see if it stands. Jaden's helmet came off, so he'll have to come out. Here's Glenn Bamblett. Face mask on Central. So four for Jaden, plus 15 more, and the Bulldogs just like that down inside the red zone. Hey, let's set the offensive line for this Wiley Bulldog offense. Gabe Montelongo, the 250-pound senior, he's your center tonight. Cade Burke, the 225-pound junior, he's at left guard. Your left tackle is Cameron Van, the senior captain, 310-pound senior. We'll set the right side after first and 10 at the 19. Ming take the snap. Throw Evans, fade pattern, knocked away at the last second. Flag flies, though. And this will be in the area of a pass interference. The ball was a little bit underthrown. Derek trying to come back to it. And the defender, Michael Duran, did not see the football and hit Derek as he was trying to leap up and make a catch. So that will be another pest patrol penalty flag, and the Bulldogs should be down inside the 10-yard line. We're setting that offensive line. Let's finish it out. Bryce Brozovic, the start tonight at the right guard. He's 315-pound junior. And Sutton Peck, the 6'3", 315-pound junior, starts at right tackle. That's a lot of beef up there. Brozovic at 315, Peck at 315, Van at 310. So they stop it to play here on the field. Give us a chance to say special thanks to some of our great sponsors of Wiley Bulldog Football. Taylor Electric Cooperative, you've heard from them. Taylor Electric Cooperative, still owned by the members it serves. Neighbors working for neighbors. Services for living, connections for life. Taylor Electric Cooperative. Also, Borland Soben and Partners Dentistry, providing the best care possible, from routine checkups and cleanings to dental implants and orthodontics. Find them online at bspdentistry.com. Also, First Financial Bank, they're our game sponsor tonight for Homecoming 2023. Their success comes from lifelong relationships they've built with people just like you. Recognized as one of the nation's top-performing banks, First Financial Bank. So it is a pass interference. The Bulldogs first and goal now, just inside the five-yard line. Trying to build on this 10-0 lead early in the second quarter. Malachi Daniels back in at the Wildcat. He'll take it. He'll off the right tackle. Sprints to the near pylon. Dives for it, and he's got it. It's a Wiley Bulldog touchdown. Malachi Daniels from 4 yards out. For Malachi on the year, it's touchdown number 4. It's 16-0 Bulldogs with an extra point to come. Everything going the way of the purple and gold tonight.
Yeah, great job by the offensive line. Great job by the Wildcat formation. Always good when you go to change it up a little bit and execute that for a touchdown. Great job by Malachi.
Brady Clark in for the PAT. Snap is back. Hold is down. Brady's kick is on the way. And it is good. 11:03 left before the half. Our score, Wiley 17, Central 0. Bulldog football powered by Taylor Electric Cooperative. The Wiley Bulldog Sports Network, 106.3 The Raider.
Everyone should have access to a bright financial future. Because when everyone succeeds, we all do better. That's why Abilene Teachers Federal Credit Union provides the tools and resources to help make your dreams come true. From buying your first home, to taking the vacation of a lifetime, to saving for retirement, we're here to help you achieve your goals. We serve everyday people in everyday life. Abilene Teachers Federal Credit Union. Everyone's welcome. Equal housing lender. Member NCUA.
17-0 Bulldogs. Three offensive possessions and three scores. The last one, a Malachi Daniels 4-yard touchdown run. Just four plays to go 75 yards for the Bulldogs. Brady Clark's extra point makes it 17-0.
And a little bit of everything. I mean, obviously just the four plays, but Lacero, great job running the football. Sprinkled in with a big Derek Evans catch. And then, of course, the touchdown, Malachi running in.
Bulldogs just surpassed 150 yards of offense here in the first half. Bear Ming, 5 of 6 for 104 thus far. Derek Evans has 68 of those. Here's Brady Clark's kickoff. First time into this wind. Pushing south to north. Returnable here. Center of the field, Malik Cates. Across the 15 to about the 20, 21, and that's it. It's the senior. He wears number 4, Peace Stone. Peyton Stone making that tackle. Great special teams play there. Peyton wrestles him around. That's a nice-looking tackle there from the senior. First to 10 here, Bobcats at the 22. Down to the sideline. Hey, Dustin Tatro, I know you're down there somewhere. What's up down there, man?
Man, I don't know if you could catch it from your vantage point, but some great agility by Malachi Daniels getting into the end zone on that one.
Okay. You don't see him stretch that Wildcat play off tackle very often, but it was a race to the near pylon, and he wins it. So now 17-0 on the scoreboard. Christian English and company back to work. First and 10, they start their own 22. English take the snap. He'll pull it on the run-pass option, and he's out across the 25 to about the 26. Four more there. I see Isaiah Valero in that defensive front. Of course, Isaiah had the big pressure a couple weeks ago at Lubbock Cooper that forced the pick six Andre Jerpy touchdown a few weeks ago.
And you wonder if Coach Crane and the offensive coordinator for the Bobcats start putting the ball in English's hands more, maybe getting out, rolling him out, put that option where he can run or throw the football.
Second and six from the 26. Brawley will get a handoff here. He's met right in the hole. He will fall forward. Melo Martinez, the middle linebacker, wraps him up, brings him down. It is four for Brawley. Third down and two here, and now it seems like Central trying to establish the run here as much as they threw it there in the first quarter. 15 pass attempts already. And now whistle and, I believe, a defensive timeout here by the Bulldogs. Didn't have the right personnel or the 11 on the field that they wanted. Coach Cates, Coach Martin say, hey, let's go ahead and call timeout here. It's a big play, third down and two. 9:59 left in our first quarter of play. Or check that. I'm sorry, our second quarter of play. It's Wiley 17 and Central 0. Take a look at the out-of-town District 2-5A scoreboard tonight. Again, this is the last week for non-district games for District 2-5A. Of course, Wiley here with San Angelo Central. Andrews and Lubbock High were playing. The Westerners, 2-2 on the year, were hosting Andrews. That was an afternoon kick. At last check, Andrews was up 28-7. Big one tonight in Wichita Falls. Wichita Falls Rider playing host to Stephenville. Of course, we saw the Yellow Jackets last week. We'll see the Raiders in about 3 weeks here at Hugh Sandifer Stadium. Plainview is 4-0, the only undefeated in District 2-5A. They take on a 4-0 Hereford team tonight in Hereford. Abilene Cooper at home tonight playing host to Odessa Permian. And Paladuro is also at home playing host to Canyon Randall. That's the look at the District 2-5A schedule. We'll keep you up to date with scores as the night continues. Out of the timeouts, third down and two. Ball's at the 30-yard line. English running the option, going right, finds a seam. He's in the open field, and he's down the sideline, and it looks like he'll take this one to the house. Plenty of speed for Christian English, and he's in the end zone. It's a 70-yard San Angelo Central touchdown. And the Bobcats, a little bit of life here in the second quarter, 17-6 now, Bulldogs, with an extra point to come. And that's the scary part about this Central offense. It's Christian English is something impressive. He found a seam, he got in the second level, and took it down the far sideline for the touchdown.
And when you score quick, you can get right back in the game really quickly like that. And again, English very dual threat tonight with his legs.
Brian Parra is the kicker, he's in for the extra point attempt. Snap is back, the hold is down, and Parra's kick is up, and it is good. 9:48 left, second quarter. It's now Wiley 17 and Central 7. Bulldog football powered by Taylor Electric Cooperative, the Wiley Bulldog Sports Network, 106.3 The Raider.
The best tailgates start with the best beef. And the best beef starts with United Supermarkets. United Supermarkets, where we do beef the best.
Expect it to be a beautiful night here in the big country.
The kickoff, a fair catch called for, and the Bulldogs will start on their own 25-yard line. Christian English, the long run to get the Bobcats on the scoreboard. 70-yard touchdown run. It capped off just a three-play drive, 78 yards. So 17-7 here, the Bulldogs back on the field offensively. Three offensive drives, three scores. Brady Clark, 27-yard field goal. Bear Ming to Riley Robinson, 24-yard touchdown pass, and the Malachi Daniels, 4-yard touchdown run. First and 10, Bulldogs on their own 25. Send motion across the formation. Hand off Julius Lane, the sophomore. He's back in uniform tonight. His first carry will get him two. Good to see Juju back. Hadn't seen him in the last few weeks, but he is back on the field. So pick up two, second down and eight.
Yeah, it's good when you have some weapons that have been out for a little bit back in the lineup. It's nice to have.
Second and 8 at the 27. Ming take the snap. Play action this time. He's just going to keep it. And loses one on the play. I think that might have been a different play design, but the play kind of imploded. Bear just had to tuck it and run, and he lost a yard. Quickly, third down and 9 here for the Bulldog offense.
And I may be mistaken. This is really kind of our first third and really, I mean, it's not real long, but our first and long that we've had in this first half. And so it'll be interesting to see what we dial up here.
8:50 left before the half. Bulldogs a 17-7 lead. Ming take the snap, roll the pocket to his right. Has a little bit of pressure. Throw it center of the field. Riley Robinson makes the catch. Takes a big hit, but hangs on to the pigskin. Bulldogs needed 9. Riley Robinson gives them 10. First and 10, Bulldogs.
Yeah, really great job by Riley. If he would have been an offensive lineman, they would have called that a chop block. He caught high load there. Great job hanging on to it, knowing where to get to the sticks and get the first down.
So first and 10, Wiley on their own 36. It's on the right hash. 4 receiver set. Take the snap. Julius Lane, another carry off the right side. Finds a little seam. He's across the 40 to about the 43. Very patient there as he waited for his blocks to set up. Sutton Peck, Bryce Brozovic on that right side. Julius able to pick up 7 on the play.
Yeah, that's when you just become the trailer and follow the truck, and he did a great job picking up a big gain there.
So second down and 3 now at the 43. Ming take the snap. Hand off Julius again off that right side. No, not much room to run this time. No gain on this play. But still set up nicely here, third down and 3. Well, it's so good to see Julius back. Last year we were able to call him Julius Lane, the freshman, all year long. I told him, I was like, I can't say that anymore. So Julius Lane, the sophomore now. Third and 3. Ball's on that right hash. Offensive coordinator Chris Kincaid, a long play call here to Bear Ming. He'll relay it to his offensive line. Clap the hands together. Third and 3. Fade pattern. Evans near side. It's up for grabs, and Derek's got it. He's down inside the central 30. 29 more for the senior, Derek Evans. First down and 10.
Really good to see number 82 in the lineup there. Great job. Got separation. Went up and got it. You got Moss.
Bulldogs will go fast from the 29. Take the snap. Lane. No play action. Bear, he'll just throw this one out. It was play action. He wanted to hit Evans on a post route. It was double covered. There was not a second option on the right side of the field, so Bear just throws that away. If you're wondering where the name Bear came from, his real first name is Bryant. Bear Bryant. There's where the nickname
Bear. There you go.
There you go.
And for those that are curious, he was coaching at Alabama way before Nick Saban. Some are now Googling Bear Bryant.
Here's second and 10 on the 29. Quarterback draw. Ming, center of the field. Leaps over a linebacker down to the 20-yard line. Sports Center highlight for Bear Ming. Just leaped over the middle linebacker. He's got 9. It's third down and 1.
I think he just got entered to the 110 hurdles and 300 hurdles there.
That play puts the Bulldogs over 200 yards of offense here in the first half. Third and 1 at the 20-yard line. Ming up under the center this time. Take the snap, quarterback sweep, or a sneak, excuse me, with a push behind him. It'll all depend on a spot. I think he's got it, and yes, he does. Bulldogs needed 1, and Ming gives him 1. First down at 10.
I'm not going to lie. For a lot of these quarterbacks, you need a passport. They've not been under center in a long time. They needed a passport.
In the red zone at the 19. Clock runs, 6:11, 6:10 left before the half. Wiley 17, Central 7. Ming, call for the snap. It's Julius Lane off the left side this time. Not much of a gain as he's met right in the hole. Wyatt Buck, 6'1", 185-pound defensive end. Not the biggest of guys, but he wrestles down Julius there. Forward progress will give Julius 2. Second down and 8. Three receiver set. It's Riley Robinson. Derek Evans on the near side. Hunter Hood, the lone receiver, on the far side. Brendan Underwood, an H-back. He's offset to the right. Ming gets rid of it in a hurry. Robinson, near side. He's inside the 15. Gang tackled at about the 14. Flag flies on the far side. 4-yard gain on the play for Robinson. And The flag is 40 yards away. Dustin, I don't know if you got a look at it. I'll come ask you. Dustin, any look?
It did kind of look like we had some interference there.
So we'll wait on the call. It's a dead ball foul.
There you go.
Personal foul on the Bobcats. So the four-yard pass and catch will stand. A personal foul will move it half the distance to the goal. Bulldogs a first down and goal.
And again, Andy, that's one of those things Coach Crane's going to be frustrated. You get a bit of a stop, and then you give them a free set of downs inside the goal, inside, you know, first and goal here. Again, that's going to be frustrating. I'm surprised he's not calling timeout.
First and goal on the 7. Trips to the wide side of the field, the left. Ming, play action, pressure off the edge, scrambles out to the right, throw it near side. It's caught in the end zone. It's a Wiley Bulldog touchdown. It's Derek Evans, the senior, from 7 yards out. For Derek, that's touchdown number 5 on the year. 4 offensive possessions and 4 scores. 23-7 Bulldogs with an extra point to come.
And a great answer by Coach Kincaid and the offense. You get punched in the mouth a little bit with a big run by English. Answer with a touchdown of your own.
It's Brady Clark getting a workout tonight with that right leg. He's in for the extra point. Snap is back. The hold is down. Flags fly. Central in the neutral zone. Brady hooked this one to the left. He'll get another chance again as the Bobcats were in the neutral zone.
This is when the mulligan's going to be beneficial. Yeah.
The Bulldogs, I love it on the special teams. They're all up in 2-point stances, and they all go down in a 3-point stance. And when they do that, we've seen a lot of special teams units jump in that neutral zone. Beneficial here for Brady. He'll get another chance. About a yard closer. Snap is back. Hold is down. Brady's extra point is up. And this one's good. We got 4:55 left. Our score, Wiley 24, Central 7. Bulldog football powered by Taylor Electric Cooperative. The Wiley Bulldog Sports Network, 106.3 The Raider.
At Taylor Electric Cooperative, we are more than just the services we provide. For generations, we have been the link that has connected members to our local community. From those who remember when the lights were first turned on to those who rely daily on our high-speed fiber internet, we are here to make certain that those connections never dim. Because we understand that the most important connection we will ever make is the one we make together. At Taylor Electric, we have provided generations with services for living and connections for life.
Whether an organized team sport or walk around your neighborhood, Hendrick Clinic Bone and Joint, Action Sports Medicine, and Action Physical Therapy understand the importance of keeping your family moving. From diagnosis to recovery, our team of physicians, orthopedic surgeons, and physical therapists provide personalized care for sports injuries, joint pain, and more. With state-of-the-art technology and more than 40 years of experience, our team will get you back to what keeps you moving.
24-7 Bulldogs. Bear Ming to Derek Evans. Second touchdown pass tonight for Ming. We'll give you some updated stats after Brady Clark's kickoff. It's a good one. It lays up high. Cates will catch it on the 15. He'll get to the near sideline. It's across the 25, 30, 35. Takes a big shot near sideline. But he's out at the 35, and that's where the Central offense will set up shop. Bulldogs with 221 yards of offense tonight, 65 on the ground, 156 through the air. Ming is 9 of 11 for 156.
We got a flag here, Andy, on the – I thought we might have got away with it, but a negative Ghost Rider.
So the late hit out of bounds will set up Central right around the 50-yard line, I believe. As the officials situate that, we can say thanks to our good friends at the Shed Market. The Shed Market, your local family-owned and operated one-stop shop for award-winning barbecue and the highest quality butcher shop in Abilene, Texas. You can visit them 7925 Buffalo Gap Road. That is the Shed Market. Byron and Stacy and the crew, always good enough to open up their doors on Friday mornings and feed the Wiley Bulldog football team over there at the shed. We say thanks for that as well. First and 10 Central, they'll start on their own 48. English, a straight drop. He starts to drive. Three-man pressure. He'll now scramble out to his right, throw it deep down the field, and a dive, and it's incomplete inside the 20-yard line. Intended for Malik Cates. A little bit of backyard football there as that play kind of fell apart. English good enough to keep it alive, but it overthrows Cates. It's incomplete.
And that really was probably the first time that you had mentioned it earlier about the four verticals. I mean, it was literally go deep, see what happens. And so we'll see what kind of pressure that we put on English to make those throws difficult, because if you wait too long, eventually you're going to be able to find a spot, set in, and become open. Again, pressure going to be key tonight, putting pressure on English.
Second and 10 at their own 48. English, another straight drop. Quarterback draw up the middle. 50, 45, 40, 35, 30. It's a foot race again. Hayden Wright will knock him off his feet. But, man, Christian English going to just do it by himself. He's got 31. Those have been the most effective plays as English with his leg. 137 yards rushing already. First and 10 at the Central, or check that, at the Wiley 21.
And we've seen that, the beneficial of Ming running for the Bulldogs. Again, English being able to add that to Coach Crane and his offense. Really kind of has been the most successful thing they've been able to do tonight.
So clock winds, 4:20 before the half. Wiley the 24-7 lead. English a straight drop, five-man pressure, flared out. He's got Brawley out of the backfield. 15 down inside the 10, still on his feet. Gang tackled as the pile will fall forward down to about the 8-yard line. Brawley's second catch tonight garners 13. Let's go down the sideline. Let's get a view from down there with Dustin Tatro. Dustin?
Well, you know how I feel about stats, and we knew that English has a tendency to rush also, and got to get in front of him.
Just like that, it's first down and goal for the Bobcat offense. First and goal at the 8. Ball's on the right hash. Tight end to the right, lead blocker to the right as well. English take the snap, whistle, and I believe we have a false start here. Pest Patrol penalty flag, false start on the Bobcats. Pushing back to the 13.
And it looked like the false start, once the play started rolling, it was going to be in English's hands. And thank goodness for Weldon and the Pest Patrol penalty flag.
Used to know that number by heart. You still know it by heart?
Yeah, 673-6700. You can call or text. They'll get you taken care of. We had Weldon on the show today. Appreciate him and Mayor and all that he's doing. Great job.
So first down and goal now at the 13. Clock winds, 323, 322. 24-7 Bulldogs. Wiley scored on all four offensive possessions tonight. And now a whistle, and I believe Kevin Crane and the Bobcats have called a timeout. So we'll keep it here. We want to remind you, coming up here at halftime, we'll have the Lawrence Hall Chevrolet Halftime Show. As part of that, the Intune Music and Sound Pure Gold Band Halftime Show performance. You'll see the Wiley Bells. You'll see the Wiley Pure Gold Band, and they look sharp in their brand-new uniforms that they will sport for the first time here at Hugh Sandifer Stadium. You'll see those in that Intune Music and Sound Pure Gold Band Halftime Show performance. And, of course, here at Homecoming, we're going to have the crowning of the homecoming queen here in 2023. Five young ladies will be introduced to the crowd. One of them will be crowned the homecoming queen here at Wiley High School this year. All of that is part of the Lawrence Hall Chevrolet Halftime Show. Again, looking ahead as well, the Bulldogs have next Friday off. It's the open date as we close out the non-district portion of the schedule. No game next Friday. District starts 2 weeks from tonight. We'll be in Plainview. Bulldogs versus Bulldogs. Wiley versus Plainview. And again, Plainview right now, the only undefeated team left in District 2-5A. Out of the timeout, 3:15 on the first half clock. Wiley, the 24-7 lead. Central first and goal at the 13. English, a straight drop. Pressure, he'll scramble to his right. Throw it out, and it's caught on the run. Catch made by Evans. Check that. I'm sorry, that's Cates who makes the catch. Cates has the penalty yardage back on his first catch tonight. 5 on the pass and catch. Second and goal from the 8.
Carpenter was in pursuit of English, but wasn't able to get to him. And again, now we've got second down and goal.
English now 9 of 18 on the night. Just 96 yards through the air. Second and goal from the 8. Take the snap. Handoff up the middle, inside the 5, inside the end zone. It's Colton Farmer with the touchdown. His first carry tonight, the 8-yard touchdown. And it's 24-13. Wiley the lead, a central extra point to follow. We knew they'd put some points on the board. They averaged 36 a game. So we knew they'd... We're able to put some points on the board, and they have thus far. Brian Parra in for the extra point. Snap is back. Hold is down. Parra's extra point is up and good. 3:04 left before the half. Our new score, Wiley 24, Central 14. We take the timeout. Wiley Bulldog football powered by Taylor Electric Cooperative on the Wiley Bulldog Sports Network, 106.3 The Raider.
At Borland Soben & Partners, we're in our third decade of providing high-quality, affordable dental care in Abilene and the Big Country. Our family-friendly clinic offers comprehensive dental care for adults and children. Anything from hygiene and preventative care to cosmetic dentistry and dental implants. And don't worry, we do emergency services too. Our team of professionals understands the latest dental techniques and technology and welcome your questions as we develop the perfect treatment plan for you. And best of all, we offer same-day appointments if you're in pain. So schedule your appointment today, and we'll see you soon.
Searching for an internet provider for your home or business? Westex Connect is celebrating 20 years of providing fast, reliable wireless internet with products and services to meet the needs of both residential and business class. Westex Connect offers packages designed to meet your budget, so you can stream all your favorite music, movies, and shows, and play the hottest games with fast, reliable in-home Wi-Fi. And Westex Connect is local, just a phone call away. Call 325-673-1930 or log on to WTConnect.com.
Here is the kickoff. Chance to return one. Jaden Lucero out across the 20, across the 25. Penalty flag flies. As Lucero tackled at the 27. This flag probably in the area of a block in the back or a hold on the Bulldogs. And it is. You're guaranteed to have some holding on homecoming.
Yes. You just, yeah, that's true. So, you're going to have some holding. Yeah.
So there's one on the Bulldogs. 24-14 on the scoreboard. Colton Farmer in from 8 yards out. 5-play, 52-yard drive, 1:45 off of the clock. Still plenty of time to work with here for the Bulldog offense, but a long field ahead, first and 10 on their own 10 after the penalty.
And again, I mentioned earlier, nobody wants to be scheduled for homecoming. Again, a big battle last year between these two schools. San Angelo going to keep battling, and being able to score quickly allows you to get back in the ballgame. Worst starting field position for the Bulldogs here at their own 10.
On the right hash, first play of the drive, it's Malachi Daniels. Just falls forward. He's hit right at the line. Malachi will get two more. I love the balance tonight, play calling wise. Of course, the yardage is leaning towards passing. But the play calling seems very balanced. Matter of fact, more run plays tonight than pass. It's second and 8, ball's at the 12. Still on that right hash. Ming, call for it, get rid of it in a hurry. It's Cooper Jones again, his third catch tonight. He's across the 15 and stacked up there. Forward progress to the 17. There's 5 more, his third catch tonight. Third down and 3 coming up. And let's get down to the sideline. Let's visit with Dustin Tatro, get a sideline report. Dustin?
You know, we're doing a pretty good job completing passes tonight. It's just they have a very thick defense, it seems like.
Able to get in and make that play in a hurry. Just under 2 minutes we go. Third down and 3. Bulldogs on their own 17. Trips receivers to the right side of the formation. That's the wide side of the field. Ming take the snap. Scrambles out to his right. Has room to run if he wants to. Still surveys. Now he'll get up the field. He finds Evans. Flag flies. Evans across the 40. I'm afraid Ming might have been across the line of scrimmage. Either that or a legal man downfield.
Well, it makes you wonder if Ming might have got cross the line of scrimmage.
It's either a legal forward pass or a legal man downfield on the Bulldogs. Kept the play alive with his feet.
Yep.
But the flag does fly. Going up the field were some offensive linemen. They got caught. Kind of got caught in no man's land. It looked like Bear might have wanted to scramble on the play, and then he throws it last second. 5-yard penalty, third down and 8, now to 12.
Now, if he played for Trent, he could have gone out for a pass, but not here at Wiley. But a great job by Derek finding a way to get open. Cooper Jones needed to do a good job of that as well coming back, but third down and long again.
Third and 8 from the 12, 1:37 left before the half. Ming flared out of the backfield. Daniels to the 15, falls forward. Boy, it's close. It'll depend on a spot. He needed the 20. Boy, it's all dependent on a spot there on Malachi's first catch tonight.
Moving him.
It's an 8-yard gain. It's first and 10, Bulldogs right at the 20-yard line.
Great second effort by Malachi to know where you needed to go. Must have saw that yellow line on TV.
Clock becoming a factor now. 1:12 and counting. First and 10 on the 20. Ming take the snap. Malachi's got it off the left side. He's out across the 25, or right at the 25. Five more for Malachi. Two timeouts for the Bulldogs. Still pretty content here to run clock. Do have a 10-point lead at 24-14. They get the football to start the second half as well. Second and 5 from the 25. Ming. Give it to Daniels again. Gets through some traffic, has a first down as he inches forward to the 32. Seven more for Malachi, first down and 10. Little urgency here now for the Bulldogs, first and 10 on the 32. Ming looks to his left, has some pressure, sidesteps one defender. He'll get a few as he keeps it, tucks it to the 35, and there's the timeout. Clay Martin will go ahead and call the second timeout here the first half. 33 seconds left before the half. Still a long field to go at the 35.
Yeah, now you're going to have one timeout, but, you know, you kind of want to maybe take advantage of that. Yes, you're getting the ball to start the second half. They just scored. They've shown they're getting a little life offensively. Kind of shocked on a little bit of the patience that Coach Kincaid's doing here. Maybe he's trying to lull them to sleep. Again, we've been able to connect Ming to Evans on some big, long touchdown passes. Robinson earlier. So it'll be interesting to see how they handle these next couple plays, these next 35 seconds. And, again, Central has two timeouts as well, knowing they're not going to get the ball. They may be just content going to make adjustments as well.
Put a few seconds back on the clock. It's back up to 35 seconds. Coach Martin called that timeout. So 35 seconds on the first half clock. Wiley 24, Central 14. Bulldogs 4 offensive possessions and 4 scores. This is their 5th possession of the night. But again, at their own 35, 35 seconds on the first half clock. It's second down and 7 at that 35. Ming with trips to his right. Daniels offset to his right. Take the snap, looks to his right, throw the out pattern in the flat. Malachi lost the football. Did he catch it and fumble it, or was it incomplete? We'll see what the officials say. It's an incomplete pass. Well, that was close as Malachi started to turn the head and turn upfield and then lost the football, but it is an incomplete pass.
I never thought he had it, and they can't challenge it, so that's a good thing. Yeah. It looked like he was trying to run with it before he packed it.
Yep. Dustin, did you have a look at it down there at all?
That's what it looked like. He thought he had it and took off running, but didn't quite.
So our eyes on the field down there, Dustin Tatro. Third down at 7 now. Ball at the 35, 27 seconds before the half. Ming, straight drop, air it out. Evans, near side, one-on-one, and it's overthrown, incomplete. There is a flag down. We'll check the flag. There's actually 2 now as the official throws his hat as well. He'd already thrown his flag. Now he's throwing his hat. I think we might have defensive holding and defensive pass interference.
And the funny thing about that, Mr. Michael Duran, is when you do the, like, don't bring it in my house, but you hold and do pass interference, that's not a very good touchdown dance, sir.
We'll see the call here from Glenn Bamlett. Holding is declined. Pass interference will be accepted. The Bulldogs will be right around the 50-yard line. Just 20 seconds to work with. Well, that's been the play of choice tonight. It's just the fly pattern to Derek Evans. It's worked. Derek has four receptions, 102 yards, and a touchdown.
I think if he'd had another penalty, he'd have had to throw his car keys out there.
Now whistle, and I believe we have a timeout by San Angelo Central on the far side. Kevin Crane's going to try to give his guys a breather here.
A little bit of a wind situation. I mean, it's not a strong wind, but it's a pretty decent breeze. So trying to figure out where you need to go, you probably know it was better as anybody. Where do you think Brady would need to get to have a chance to make a field goal?
I think Brady could be good from 45. So that would put, you know, you need to get to the 35-yard line. So you need about the 28-yard line, I would think, to give Brady a chance. Yeah, the wind will be in his face a little bit, but I think Brady could be good from 45.
Again, Coach Martin still has the one timeout left. So a lot of options with 20 seconds. We've got, again, you mentioned being able to send Derek deep. Been a great fly opportunity there. But now you start wondering, does Robinson come open? Does Hood? We've seen that the last couple of weeks where somebody random pops up. We haven't seen the quick post pattern that we've seen a lot with the play action.
Yep. Evans is out on this play. Gage Heighton, the junior, is in on the near side. He, Cooper Jones, Hunter Hood are all in. First and 10, ball's right at the 50-yard line. Ming, a straight drop, get it out in the flat again. Malachi on the near side, he'll get out of bounds on another catch. Six on the play, 15 seconds on the clock. Ball's on the 44. Second down and four from here. Still one timeout for the Bulldogs. You want to try to hold on to that as long as you can.
Great job by the senior Malachi getting out of bounds and stopping the clock.
Second and four from the Central 44 now. Ming looks to his left this time. It's the same play. Daniels just on the left side. He's got a first down. Runs out of bounds again. 9 seconds on the clock. If nothing else, you've given Bear a chance to throw one in the end zone. First and 10 at the 40, but just 9 seconds now on the clock. 24-14 Bulldog lead. Evans is back on the field here near side. First and 10 at the 40. Ming take the snap. Pressure coming off the left side. He rolls to his right. Still looking. Trying to hit Cooper Jones. He'll make a leap at the sideline, but can't haul it in. Pass falls incomplete. Now just 4 seconds left. And it looks like you're probably throwing one here to the end zone, Hutch.
Yeah, I mean, I guess you can always see if Brady wanted to set a lot of school records, but I don't think it'd be worth it here.
Well, Central's certainly thinking that the Hail Mary's coming. They've sent four secondary players to the goal line.
It would be pretty.
And now here's the timeout from Clay Martin.
Be pretty poetic justice if we were to find a way to score with 4 seconds left after last year.
Well, the good thing is, if you know four are going to be at the goal line, you know it's probably just going to be three-man pressure, which would give Ming a chance to probably keep the play alive long enough to get some players down in the end zone.
Well, and the other thing is, and what happened last year in our San Angelo Central game on the road last year was it wasn't even a throw to the end zone. Yep. They found it opening in the middle of the field. And now you have to make them miss. Yep. It's kind of like baseball. Put it in play, make them make a mistake. And so you still have a lot of options here. Obviously, the timeout called, so none of those. And 4 seconds left before we crown a homecoming queen. And do you remember your last homecoming at Lorena?
I do, yeah. 1996. Already threw it out there, yeah. Yeah. So shout out to Melanie Compton. Homecoming Queen, 1996.
There you go. Shara Hammond, the old Merkel. There you go. Strolling down memory lane.
There you go.
How many people do you think have talked about the play they made for Coach Sandiford like 15, 20 years ago? If anybody's in the stands listening, get us a poll on how many Hugh Sandiford stories we've heard.
Final play of the first half from the 40-yard line. Ming, he's just going to flare it out on the near side. It's overthrown. It's incomplete. And that's how the first half will come to an end. Good first half for the Bulldogs. They'll take a 10-point lead to the halftime break. It's 24-14. Dustin.
At Taylor Electric Cooperative, we are more than just the services we provide. For generations.
24-14. Dustin, are you down there?
I am. I've got Coach Clay Martin with us. Coach, what's your thoughts on this first half? Some pretty varied techniques going on with both teams.
Yeah, you know, thought we played fairly well. You know, execution was better. And got a lead and just got to play a better second half.
And stop that other quarterback.
You what?
Stop the other quarterback.
Yes.
Stop the other quarterback. I got a eye roll on that one. Back to you guys in the booth.
All right. 24-14 is our halftime score. We'll get you into the Lawrence Hall Chevrolet halftime show. Get you the Intune Music and Sound Pure Gold Band halftime show performance. And we'll crown a homecoming queen here at halftime as well. Glad you're with us tonight. Bulldog football powered by Taylor Electric Cooperative on the Wiley Bulldog Sports Network, 106.3 The Raider.
At Wiley ISD, our career and technical education courses are designed to provide academic challenges for students. To us, it is vital for our students to earn important certifications that are recognized by industry and not only promote college readiness to further their education, but springboard students in preparation for a career in current and emerging professions. Wiley ISD, inspiring the next generation of innovators.
Twenty-four-14. It is halftime here at Hugh Sanderford Stadium. As we are going to step aside here, get you into the Lawrence Hall Chevrolet Halftime Show. Driving you in and out of halftime is Lawrence Hall Chevrolet. Lawrence Hall provides a vast selection of new and used vehicles, exceptional car care, and customer service with a smile. They're recognized as Abilene's best new car dealer by the Abilene Reporter News for more than 20 years. It is Lawrence Hall Chevrolet. We're going to give the stage to the halftime. We're going to start with our visiting team tonight, San Angelo Central. We'll let you get a view at their drill team and their band as well. Here at halftime, 24-14 is our halftime score. Again, the San Angelo Central drill team and band.
Texans are led on the field by Captain Riley Heckerman, First Lieutenant Ashlyn Scott, Senior Lieutenant Madeline Vasquez, Senior Lieutenant Emily Barboza, Senior Lieutenant Leanna Garcia, Senior Lieutenant Hannah Hernandez, Junior Lieutenant Taylor Darrell, and Junior Lieutenant Araceli Mesa. The veteran line members of the week are Nevaeh Fairfield and Natalie Salcido. The rookie line members of the week are Jersey Wyatt and Aiden Ashley. Tonight, the Texans will be performing to Tyler Cruz's number one hit, Dynamite. Let's give it up for the Central High School Texans. Thank you. for Central High School, Texas. San Angelo ISD is proud to present the award-winning Central High School Mighty Pop Band. The band is under the federation of drum majors Elizabeth Clark,
Mia Wilcox, Andy Kudinicki, and Addison Jones.
The Tarpon Music Band members of the week are Woodwind, Taylor Tambunga, and Eva Rivas. Brass, Callie Barrett, and Aiden Rudolph. Percussion, Johnny Cimino. Color Guard, Michaela Williamson, and rookies Simon Duran and Taylor Leach. The section of the week is the Mellophones. Tonight the band will present their first two movements of its 2023 field show entitled Uncharted Waters. This show follows a group of weary travelers who are challenged with a treacherous path, symbolizing the journey of life and the decisions we make while on that journey. Ladies and gentlemen, the Mighty Bobcat Band.
Thank you.
Say great job to our visiting band from tonight, the San Angelo Central Bobcats and their drill team. Great job, as always. Having the in-tune music and sound, Pure Gold Band halftime show performance. You're about to see the home team, Wiley Pure Gold Band. The Wiley Bells will be out on the field first. Then don't forget, we will have the homecoming queen ceremony coming up after the Wiley High School Band as well. In-Tune Music and Sound, the mission statement of In-Tune Music and Sound is its service. And In-Tune Music and Sound, that means providing a real service to the customer, helping you find the best answer to your unique situation. In-Tune Music and Sound. Again, under the direction of Laurel Lemke, our Wiley High School Bells, followed by the Wiley Pure Gold Band in their brand new uniforms and looking sharp. They're under the direction of band director Kyle McDonald. We turn it back over to the field here in the Wiley High School Bells.
Please welcome to the field the 11th line of your Wiley Varsity Bells. Thank you to our gold sponsors, First Watch Credit Union, The Shed, Abilene Police Officers Association, The Kings Collective, Gymnastics Sports Center, Rex Richards, and Jay's Barbecue. Officers for the Bells are Captain Laura Preston, Lieutenant Audrey Alvarado, Lieutenant Catherine Anderson, Lieutenant Abby Bulls, Lieutenant Kinley Long, and Lieutenant Avery New. Social President Kylie Tylen, Social Vice President Chloe Ripple, and Bell of the Week, Tara Clement. Bells would like to thank their star sponsors from this year: Well Kids MD, Radiology Associates, ATF CU Bank, USG, Carlton Orthodontist, Frank and Amber Peck, McDonald's Dave Harmon, Angie Marcellus Akala Realtor, Prep Academy Dance Studio, Pico Cape and Son, Willis Supply Company, Dr. Jessica Ortolano, Mira Enterprises, Apricot Lane, Matt Preston Edward Jones, Redwood Built LLC, Clear Fork Bank, Tristan Love Mortgage, Love and Love Mortgage, Sika Industrial Sales, Amber Sanders Realtor Sendero Properties, LLC, Raven Directional, Black Plumbing Services, and Mad Hatter Motorsports. Bells are under the direction of Laura Lemke and will now perform a field kick to California Girls.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Making their way onto the field, Wiley Independent School District is proud to introduce you to your 2023 Wiley Pure Gold Band. Our field production this year is entitled Forge and was programmed by Jason Robb with choreography by Sierra Rogers, arranged by Evan Van Doren, and featuring the music of Dmitry Shostakovich, Coldplay, and Otorino Respighi. Forged is based on the God of Thunder and the creation of the most feared weapon in the nine Norse realms, Thor's hammer Mjolnir. Forged by the Dwarven brothers Brock and Sindre Mjolnir, the hammer is a powerful source of energy and destruction. Color Guard is led by our Captain Morgan Dean, with Lieutenants Haley Castro and Paige Perkins. Performers of the week are Ava Ramos, Naomi Rankin, Cannon Hale, and Giselle Rodriguez. Section of the week goes to the Color Guard. Soloist for our performance is Nick Hymus on euphonium. The Pure Gold Band is under the field direction of drum majors Allison McCall, Addie Filona, and McKenna Herbert. Drum majors, you may begin tonight's halftime performance of Forge.
Thank you. Thank you. directors of the Pure Gold Band are Kyle McDonald, Ashlyn Ray, Louis Bell, Chris Brand, Carolyn Garcia, Marissa Leitz, and John De La Garza.
And again, a look at the Wiley High School Pure Gold Band. Boy, doesn't the uniforms look great tonight. Our Pure Gold Band performance brought to you by Intune Music and Sound. Mission statement of Intune Music and Sound is the service. And at Intune Music and Sound, that means providing a real service to the customers, helping you find the best answer to your unique situation. Intune Music and Sound. This is the Lawrence Hall Chevrolet Halftime Show here at the half. It is Wiley 24, San Angelo Central 14. Stay with us. We're about to have the crowning of the homecoming queen here 2023. You'll see that here on the near sideline. You'll hear that announced from our public address announcer, Cameron Wiley. And we'll have that getting started here very, very soon. Lawrence Hall Chevrolet Halftime Show.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We welcome all of you to Wiley High School Homecoming 2023. At this time, we are proud to present the nominees for Homecoming Queen. The WHS senior class of 2024 selected these five senior girls. They were then voted upon by the entire WHS student body. Ashton Hansen is the daughter of Julie Williams and Jay and Christy Hansen. She is the granddaughter of Bruce and Pam Massey, Al and Carol Pickett, Jerry and Gail Hansen, David and Sherry Roberts, and Tim and Jackie Abney. Ashton attends Beltway Park Church. While attending Wiley High School, Ashton has been a class officer and played volleyball for all 4 years. Ashton has also been a Western Heritage Classic Rhinestone girl and coaches youth volleyball. After graduation, Ashton plans to attend Texas Tech University, where she plans to pursue a degree in nursing. Ashton is escorted by her father, Jay Hansen. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Ashton Hansen. Paige Hughes is the daughter of Derek and Alexis Hughes. She is the granddaughter of Charles and Judy Hughes and Judy Hubbard. Paige attends Wiley Methodist Church. While attending Wiley High School, Paige has been a class officer her sophomore, junior, and senior years. She has been a member of both varsity cheerleading and varsity track. She is also involved in National Honor Society, Fellowship of Christian Athletes, and PALS. Paige has been a Western Heritage Classic Rhinestone girl. Paige volunteers at Camp Rehab and serves as a mentor with Pup Squad and Adopted Cheerleader. After graduation, Paige plans to major in nursing so she can serve in the labor and delivery wing. Paige is escorted by her father, Derek Hughes. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Paige Hughes. Zara Manser is the daughter of Kawai and Holly Manser. She is the granddaughter of Bill and Cheryl Beetson. Manasseh Manser, David and Sherry Moore, and Allie and Sandra Jesperson. She is a member of The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, where she is a youth leader and counselor at summer camps. While attending Wiley High School, Zara has served as senior class secretary and is currently a member of National Honor Society. She is also a member of PALS, Purple Dog Company, Student to Student, and Unified Bulldogs program. After graduation, Zara plans to attend Texas A&M University, where she plans to major in hospitality management and tourism. Zara is escorted by her mother, Holly Manser. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Zara Manser. Laura Preston is the daughter of Matt and Shauna Preston. She is the granddaughter of Harold and Susan Preston, Becky Shergerick, and the late Donald Shergerick. She is a member of First Baptist Church. Laura is the senior class treasurer and captain for the Wiley Bells. She is a member of National Honor Society, PALS, and will be performing in the dance ensemble of the fall musical Mamma Mia. Laura is also a company member of Abilene Ballet Theater and was selected to attend the Joffrey Ballet School in New York. She has volunteered with the City Lights Community Ministries and the Abilene Philharmonic Bells. After graduation, Laura plans to attend Texas A&M University to attend a Bachelor of Business Administration in Accounting. Laura is escorted by her father, Matt Preston. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Laura Preston. Wesley Ruff is the daughter of Corey and Jason Ruff. She is the granddaughter of Bob and Teeny Benham and Bill and B. Ruff. She is a member of Southern Hills Church of Christ. Wesley has played volleyball all 4 years. She earned first team all-district and academic all-district as a junior and is currently co-captain of the varsity team. Wesley is also a member of National Honor Society and is actively involved in her church youth group. After graduation, Wesley plans to attend Abilene Christian University to major in marketing and entrepreneurship, then pursue a law degree. Wesley is escorted by her father, Corey Ruff. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Wesley Ruff. The homecoming queen and her court will be presented and crowned this evening by Colby Anderson, son of Drs. John and Rachel Anderson, Evan Ashley, son of Josh and Sarah Ashley, Dennis Marcourt, son of Dennis and Monique Marcourt, Kyle Page, son of Heath and Julie Page, and Luke Powell, son of John and Jackie Powell. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your Wiley High School homecoming queen of 2023 is Miss Laura Preston.
So a congratulations to Laura Preston, the 2023 homecoming queen here at Wiley High School. Special nights for her as well as all five of the beautiful young ladies out there and the whole senior class of 2024. We say enjoy the festivities this weekend.
Let's give one last round of applause for all of our homecoming queen nominees.
Again, the crowd, a nice applause to all of them. Laura Preston, again, congratulations, the homecoming queen here in 2023. Hodge, welcome back in. We hadn't even talked football here at half, 24-14. The Bulldogs a 10-point lead and good 24 minutes of football. Now they get a chance to replicate it here in the second half.
Well, and again, it always comes with homecoming. I don't care where you're at. There's always extra festivities, longer halftime, great performance by the band. Again, homecoming court out there getting their photos and a memory they'll remember forever and again. But the first half, a lot of good things happening. A lot of, over 250 yards of offense.
259, yep.
Ming got comfortable. Great job bounce back from Derek Evans. But with this long delay gives a lot of people on both sides, coaching staffs, adjustments to be made. Now you got to get that motor running again, going to start off with the football or the Bulldogs. And so it's just going to be real important to kind of keep that thing going because we've seen how quickly San Angelo can score and to go ahead and put your foot on that pedal, if you will, throat, wherever you want to put it, and really press down and finish this half.
Bear Ming, 13 of 18 in that first half, 177 yards and two touchdown passes. Derek Evans in the first half, four receptions for 102 yards. Riley Robinson had three receptions for 38, both of those guys with touchdowns. Malachi Daniels, three receptions for 18. Cooper Jones, three receptions for 19 there in the first half. Malachi on the ground, 10 carries for 35 yards. Bear had six carries for 23. Four carries for Julius Lane for 11. Two carries for Jaden Lucero for 13. Add it all up, 259 yards of offense there in the first half. For Central, they had 242 yards of offense in the first half. Christian English on the ground had six carries for 137 yards. That included the 70-yard touchdown run that he had there in the first half. English started hot, throwing the football, but tailed off as the half continued. He finished 9 of 18 in that first half for 96 yards through the air. Again, 9 of 18 for 86 yards. 24-14 is our score. We thank InTune Music and Sound for their sponsor of the Wiley Pure Gold Band halftime show performance. And Lawrence Hall Chevrolet, our halftime show sponsor, driving us in and out of halftime. Lawrence Hall Chevrolet, providing a vast selection of new and used vehicles, exceptional car care, and customer service with a smile. Recognized as Abilene's best new car dealer by the Abilene Reporter News for more than 20 years. That's Lawrence Hall Chevrolet. So we get ready for the second half. Again, the Bulldogs won the toss, deferred to the second half. So we'll see Wiley get the footballs. They'll take it here to start the second half of play. Five offensive possessions in the first half, four scores. The only one was the right there at the end of the first half, where time became an issue. Here is the kickoff. It will go out of the back of the end zone. It is a touchback. So the Bulldogs will start first down and 10 at their own 25. 259 yards of offense, 82 on the ground, 177 through the air for the 259. So first and 10 on the 25.
And really in the first half had pretty good field position each time except the one where we started on our own 10. But, again, still got some points.
It's Ming and company. He'll start with a two-receiver set, tied in to his right. H-back to the right as well. Malachi will get it off the right guard. Just push the pile forward. Malachi is good for three or four every time he carries the football. He's got three there. That's 11 carries now, 38 yards on the night. And second down is seven now at the 28. Bulldogs kind of going a power set here to start the second half. Tight end to the right, H-back Brendan Underwood, offset to the left. Take the snap, it's Malachi again. Finds a little seam, he's across the 30, close to a first down, knocked off his feet at the 34. Michael Duran, the corner, makes the stop, but it's six more, and Hodge, this is the play as you like here. Third down is short, the 34-yard line.
Yeah, again, we've been sitting over there for a long time. They've been stretching, going through all the routines, third down and short. Interesting to see what we dial up here.
From the 34, Ming take the snap. It's Malachi again. He'll have a first down. We'll move the sticks. He's out to the 38. Haven't seen Derek Evans yet here in the second half. Derek, big first half, but he did come up after one of his receptions. Looked like he had the wind knocked out of him. Haven't seen him yet here in the second half. So again, Bulldogs gone a little bit more of a power look here. First and 10 at the 38. Just underway in the second half. Bulldogs 24, Bobcats 14. Ming take the snap. It's Daniels again. He's across the 40, driving forward to about the 44. Six more for Malachi. Four straight plays out of the chute to start the second half.
And it's really good. Cade Burke, great job getting to the second level on the run, on the play. Great job by Cade Burke getting to the second level with the block.
Again, second down and very manageable here. Second down and four at the 44. Ming slapped the hands together. It's Malachi, fifth straight play. This off the left guard. Short gain across the 45, maybe to about the 46. Third down and about two. And what I love about here, excuse me, Hodge, hey, you're eating clock. You're moving the football with a 10-point lead. Third down and two.
Yeah, and just kind of five straight run plays, kind of maybe could set up any kind of play-action pass. But if it's working, running behind the big fellas, Kincaid probably going to keep doing it.
Third and two at the 46. Tight end to the right, and H-back to the left. Handoff as a flag flies. Malachi barrels forward. He's got a first down. We'll check the Pest Patrol penalty flags. They flew early in the play, like an illegal formation or an offside, something along that. We'll check with the official. They flew very early, like if somebody lined up in the neutral zone, and it is. Pest Patrol penalty flag, offsides on the Bobcats. Pest Patrol, family-owned and operated business. Number one focus, providing customers with the best pest control services available. That is Pest Patrol. So no carry that time from Malachi, just a five-yard penalty. First down and 10. Ball's across the midfield stripe on the plus 49, the central 49. In the center of the field, Julius Lane is in. He's offset to Ming's left. Take the snap, put it in the belly of Julius. He'll find a seam on the right side. He's down inside the 45, about the 42. Seven for Julius. And this is what we thought all year long, Hodge, is, hey, we'll give Malachi a few carries, let him catch his breath while Julius gets a few carries, and just march the football right down the field.
Well, and we've really been able to have a three-headed monster, if you will, back there in the backfield with Lucero. Malachi, yep. Now a healthy Julius.
Second down and three at the central 42. Take the snap. It's Julius again off the left guard. He's got a first down. Barrels inside the 40 to about the 38. This is man-on-man football right now. And that's four more for Julius. Move the sticks. First down and 10.
And for those of you that looked up Bear Bryant, this is probably what kind of offense he was running, just ground and pound, those that looked up Bear Bryant during halftime.
Is that seven consecutive runs to start the second half? First to 10 at the Central 37. Ming sends motion across the formation. That's Underwood. He'll throw it for the first time. Fade pattern. Far side. Hunter Hood makes a dive at the 10. Comes up empty. Had a step on the defender. Had a little of a tough time releasing at the line of scrimmage, but he did get around the defender and had a step, and Ming led him just a bit too far at the 10. And it falls incomplete. Second down at 10.
Well, and it's a great time. First down, you've been, again, you mentioned seven straight run plays. And so trying to throw up something a little different, especially with Evans not in there, just came up short.
So second and 10 at the 37. Ming take the snap. It's Julius off the right guard. Hit at the line. Breaks a tackle. He's into the secondary. Dragging defenders close to another first down. Julius hit right at the line of scrimmage. That's yards after contact and a bunch of them. I think he's shy, but he's got nine. It's third down and what you like, third down and one. Let's give some credit to those big boys up front. Gabe Montelongo, Cade Burke, Bryce Brozovic, Cameron Vann, Sutton Peck, big guys up front. Here's third and inches. Quarterback sneak. Ming's got a first down all the way down to the 24. Four for Bear on third and one. Bulldogs move to the sticks again. And we are already 4.5 minutes deep in this second half. Bulldogs 24, Bobcats 14. Just taking the air out of the football. Love it. Just inside the 25 on first and 10. Ming, play action this time. Going to air it out again. Vertical route into the end zone. A little bit underthrown and incomplete. Almost intercepted. Riley Robinson, the intended receiver, just a tad bit underthrown and almost picked off. I believe that's Colton Smith, the safety back there. Ball's incomplete, second down at 10.
Yeah, Riley had to become a defensive back there on that on that play.
So second and 10 at the Central 24. Twins to the left, H-back tight end to the right. Underwood now in motion to the left. Roll the pocket to the left. Ming squares the shoulders now, tuck it and run. He's met right at the line of scrimmage. Nice open field tackle right at the line. That's Caleb Martinson who makes that tackle. Bear decided to just tuck it and run, but he's met right at the line of scrimmage. No gain. It's third down and 10. Let's go down to the field. Let's visit with Dustin Tatro, our first time in the second half. Dustin, what's up down there?
You know, that 91-yard touchdown run last week was that grand slam. What we're doing right now is a bunch of base hits, and those will win ball games too.
No doubt about that. Dustin down on the sideline. Third down and 10, though, here from the 24. Empty backfield this time for me. Four receiver set, pressure coming off the edge. Malachi on the far sideline, he's got the catch. Flags are out, I believe Central's in the neutral zone, so this play should stand. But nobody covering Malachi on the far side. And it is, Malachi's got the catch, offsides on the play. Penalties declined, it's an 11-yard pass and catch and a Wiley Bulldog first down.
Great job by Ming, knowing pressure was coming off his right backside. Great job finding Malachi and getting the first down.
So in the red zone now, as the clock winds, 6:15 and counting, third quarter, Bulldogs a 24-14 lead. First to 10 at the Central 14. Take the snap, Daniels off the left guard, hit right at the line of scrimmage. Bobcats are starting to bring pressure off the edge. Malachi dropped for no gain on that play. Another second down and 10, but here we are, Hodge. Half of the third quarter is already gone. We might play the second half faster than halftime.
Yes, which may not take a lot to do.
We played the first 6 minutes of this third quarter in about 7 minutes, I think. 5:39, 5:38. Second down and 10, ball just inside the 15. Ming, take the snap. It's Daniels off left guard. He's into the linebacking core, knocked off his feet. At the 10, five more for Malachi. Big play here, third down and 5 coming up. Four down territory.
If it's me, yes, because we're finding a way just to score here. I would like to see a touchdown here, but again, points are points.
Third and five at the 10. Ming take the snap. Throw it, fade pattern, near side. Hunter Hood makes a leap, makes a catch. Did he get the feet down? Yes, he did. It's a Wiley Bulldog touchdown. There are flags on the play. I believe Central in the neutral zone again. We'll check it. But if that's the case, it's Bear Ming to Hunter Hood. Third touchdown pass tonight for Bear. It's 30-14 with an extra point to come. That's a how do you do. Nice 75-yard drive to start the second half.
Yeah, great job. The fade route is still, so far, been one of our best plays.
Brady Clark's in for the PAT. A 7-minute drive to open the second half with points on the board. Snap is back. The hold is down. Brady's extra point is up, and it is no good. He pushed it to the left, but still 5:04 remaining in our third quarter. Our score, Wiley 30 and Central 14. It's Bulldog football powered by Taylor Electric Cooperative, the Wiley Bulldog Sports Network, 106.3 The Raider.
At Taylor Electric Cooperative, we are more than just the services we provide. For generations, we have been the link that has connected members to our local community. From those who remember when the lights were first turned on to those who rely daily on our high-speed fiber internet, we are here to make certain that those connections never dim. Because we understand that the most important connection we will ever make is the one we make together. At Taylor Electric, we have provided generations with services for living and connections for life.
When First Financial Bank opened its doors in 1890, a relationship between a local community bank and a state was born. For more than 130 years, First Financial has grown alongside you, your family, your business, all while putting your goals first. From the ports to the plains, First Financial Bank, Weird Texas.
Hunter Hood's second touchdown reception of the season. A 10-yard pass and catch from junior teammate Bear Ming. 30-14 Bulldogs. After the impressive opening drive here in the second half, we'll recap it after Brady Clark's kickoff. Central about to touch the football for the first time in the second half at the 5:04 mark. Here's Brady's kick. This is a squib kick near side. It's through the hands of Cates. All he can do is fall on it down at the 22. And that's where the Bobcats will set up shop. Bulldog drive, 16 plays, 75 yards, 6:56 off the clock. Ming to Hood, the 10-yard pass and catch. And now 5:01 left third quarter. And Hodge, sometimes your best defense is your offense, especially when you have the lead. Milk the clock, put points on the board. Central, before you know it, down 16 and only 17 minutes of clock to work with the rest of the night.
And it makes that offense even a longer halftime that you're just now getting onto the field, getting hand cramps over here, riding all those plays, which is not a bad thing.
So Christian English and company, first and 10, play action, quick curl pattern, caught right outside the 25, the 26. Catch made by Cates. Cash Martin, Hayden Wright were both there. Give him three on the catch. Cates' second catch tonight. Central had 242 yards of offense there in that first half. English did a lot of it with his feet. He had 137. Rushing, 70-yard touchdown run, too. Here's second and seven. High snap, quick throw, caught on the outside, far side. I believe that's Hill who makes the catch and barrels forward for a nice gain. Hill's got 10. Hill was very active early in the game. That's his first catch in a while, but it is for 10 and a first down.
Colton Farmer had a really good block there to open up to create the extra yardage.
So now, first and 10 at the 36. English has trips to the short side of the field to his right. Looks to his left. Pressure scrambles to his right. Still scrambling, a hat comes out, bodies go flying. English has a short gain. Hat came out on the far side. Usually that means a receiver runs out of bounds and comes back in, is ineligible. However you look at it, it's about a three-yard gain, I believe, on the play for English. Second down at 7.
I would think if you're Coach Crane, you're trying to find a way to keep the ball in English's hands to create, whether it's with his feet or his arm.
That's when he does it best. He'll hand it off here. I believe that's Brawley on the carry. Josh Patterson, immediate contact. Brawley will fall forward for 1. Long third down coming up here. Third down and about 6. Josh Patterson playing with a cast on his right arm. He broke his thumb earlier this week. But he's out there still making plays. Third down and 6. Here for the Central offense. They're on their own 40. English, straight drop. Pressure coming up the middle. He's trying to get away from it. He can't do it. Colin Bruning, Chef Jeff with a sack. It's a 10-yard loss on the play. That's Colin's second sack of the year. He leads the team with 50 tackles on the season. It's a 10-yard loss. It's fourth down. Here come the personnel changes.
Yeah, and a great job. We've seen Coach Cates kind of back off a little bit. This time dials up pressure, sends the blitz with Colin and Chef. Dials up home cooking on homecoming.
Chef Jeff. Colin's formal name is Jeffrey, if you were wondering. And Chef Jeff came out of nowhere. As there's a punt far sideline. It'll work its way down the sideline and out of bounds at about the 30-yard line. Yeah, Chef Jeff is so popular that the Wiley High School marketing team made shirts this week. It had Chef Jeff and a graphic on the front. And I think they sold about 100 of them this week. So,
name, image, and likeness.
It's already starting. The Purple Dog Company, that marketing team that made those this week. 2:33 left, third quarter. It's Wiley 30, Central 14. And the Bulldogs have the football back, first at 10. They'll start on their own 29 this time. Updated stats now. Ming is 15 of 22 tonight, 198 yards, 3 touchdown passes. Malachi's got 61 on the ground. Send that on 17 carries. First and 10 at the 29 on the left hash. Jaden Lucero will get a chance to carry the football off the left guard. He's pushed out across the 30. Short game for Jaden. Let's get out of the field. Let's visit with Dustin Tatro, get a sideline report. Dustin?
Yeah, have you ever thrown your tortilla dough down on the counter and it just kind of goes flat?
Plop, yeah.
That's what we're seeing their offense doing against our defense. They're right where they needed to be. Something happened after halftime. Defense is on fire.
Well, they've been on a roll here the last few weeks. 9 takeaways now over the course of the last 3 games. Motion across the formation. That's Underwood. Ming rolled the pocket to his right. Has pressure. All he can do is throw this one away. Credit off the line there for Central. Their defensive line. Give it chase. I believe that's Isaiah Allen. Kaysen Robles up there as well. So pass falls incomplete. Third down and 8 here for the Bulldog offense. Ball sits on the 31.
Definitely would like to see us continue to extend this drive. Defense did a really great job kind of getting Central on a short, quick turnaround. And now I'd like to continue this drive and see if we can't milk pretty much the whole third quarter.
Third down, 8, ball on the 31. Ming, take the snap. It's Lucero off the right guard, but he's hit right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on that play. And it looks like we'll see a punt, and I believe, yeah, the first punt of the night for the Bulldog offense.
Yep.
That's their 7th possession tonight. They've scored 5 times. The first half clock ran out on them on the other drive. And this will be the first time we'll see Brady Clark in punt formation. He stands at the Bulldog just inside the Bulldog 20. Malik Cates is back deep for the Bobcats. He stands at the 35. 1:15 now left in this third quarter. Pressure coming off the edge. Brady able to get it away. It's a nice end-over-end kick. It'll land at the 40 and kind of die there, check up there, and it's down just outside the 40-yard line. 1:04 left, third quarter of play. Bulldogs 30, Bobcats 14. Hodge, how many plays was that last Central drive?
They had 5.
5 plays. So here we are at the 1:04 left in the third, and the Central offense has only run 5 plays in the second half. Tough to come back from 16 points down when you don't get the football very much. They've got it first to 10 on their own 42. It's English again. This has been the typical formation here. Twins receivers to both sides. Four receiver set. Brawley is offset to English's right this time. Take the snap. It's a straight drop. English looks to his right. Now scrambles to his left, still surveying the field. He's going to throw it up the sideline, near sideline, overthrown and incomplete. Alex Lindsay, the intended receiver, kind of got turned around. He broke off his route and just went vertical up the near sideline. Good coverage there by Jerpy Patterson. Josh Cole are all there too. Incomplete second down at 10.
Yeah, English kind of gave the old route, started to die a little bit, had plenty of times, told Lindsay, hey, take off and go deep. Just overthrew him, but great job underneath and over the top coverage by the Bulldogs.
Second down and 10, ball at the 42. Still the four receiver set. Brawley off to English's right. Whistle. I believe we have a false start here on the Bobcats. Give us a chance to say hello to Hendrick Clinic Bone and Joint. Hendrick Clinic Bone and Joint, specializing in orthopedics, sports medicine, and pain management to help you succeed through your seasons. That's Hendrick Clinic Bone and Joint. Don't forget to stay with us for the Animal Health and Medical Center post-game show. We'll give you the Abilene Glass and Mirror Player of the Game. Those will be coming your way here at the conclusion of this one. Bulldogs a 30-14 lead. It was a false start on the Bobcats. It's second down now and 15 at their own 37. English take the snap. Again, a straight drop. Wants to air this one out, and he will. Deep post pattern. It's up for grabs. It's overthrown. It's incomplete. Intended that time. I believe that's Caleb Bucks. Now check that. It's Alex Lindsay again. Lindsay kind of stopped on the route there. On the deep ball, just kind of stopped on it. It ended up being overthrown and incomplete.
Well, it's third and long here. Last time on the third down, Coach Kate sent Bruning on the blitz. We'll be curious to see if he kind of plays safe here because, again, you're 30-14, only 46 seconds left to go here in this third quarter. Do you go ahead and put pressure on him?
Third down and 15. It's a quarterback draw. English tripped up right at the line of scrimmage. It's Larry Smith Jr., the defensive end. On design quarterback draw, Smith was able just to reach his paw out there and hit him on the shin and knock him off his feet. No gain on the play. It's fourth down and 15. Here comes the punt unit again.
Be interesting to see if they give Hood a chance to even catch it. Last time kicked it basically to the sideline. So we'll see if Hood gets a chance to actually return one.
Here is the punt. It's a nice punt. Hood will get a chance to return this one. Catches it on the 24. Working his way to the near sideline. Short return across the 25. That's about it. 1 second left in our third quarter. We do have a flag on the play. We'll check that flag with 1 second left here in the quarter. It's kind of behind the play. Personal foul on the Bulldogs. Yeah, it was way away from the play, so somebody got a cheap shot in when nobody was looking except one of the Zebras, and they got him. So 30-14, 1 second left here in the third quarter. There's a good one going on in Wichita Falls. Stephenville leads Ryder 21-14. That's with about 10 minutes left. Plainview's 4-0 in district, but they're 4-0 on the year, but they're struggling tonight. Hereford leads Plainview 24-14. That game also in the fourth quarter. Permian leads Abilene Cooper 34-20. So the Cougs will be ready to get into district play. They had a tough non-district schedule. First to 10 Bulldogs after the penalty. They'll start on their own 13. Ming will take the snap, hand off. It's Julius Lane who will get the carry. Short gain for Julius. And that's how the third quarter will come to an end. We played three here at Hugh Sandifer Stadium. Our score, Wiley 30, Central 14. We take the timeout. Bulldog football powered by Taylor Electric Cooperative. Bulldog Sports Network, 106.3, the Raider.
At Borland Soben & Partners, we're in our third decade of providing high-quality, affordable dental care in Abilene and the Big Country. Our family-friendly clinic offers comprehensive dental care for adults and children. Anything from hygiene and preventative care to cosmetic dentistry and dental implants. And don't worry, we do emergency services too. Our team of professionals understands the latest dental techniques and technology and welcome your questions as we develop the perfect treatment plan for you. And best of all, we offer same-day appointments if you're in pain. So schedule your appointment today, and we'll see you soon.
When it comes to finding the right vehicle for you, there's no better place than Lawrence Hall in Abilene. For over 34 years, Lawrence Hall in Abilene has been the place to find the best from Chevrolet, Buick, and GMC. And that is still true today. Great products and great service, too. So the next time you need a new car, truck, or SUV, come see us or shop 24/7 at LawrenceHallAbileneOnline.com. Voted Abilene's best new car dealer for over 28 years by you, our customers.
Twelve minutes left on the clock tonight. It is 30-14. Bulldogs on top of San Angelo Central. Homecoming 2023. Glad you're with us. Andy Pitty alongside the Hodge, Ryan Holmes, and Dustin Tatro down on the sideline. Central offense in that third quarter had 7 total yards of offense. Barely had the football. Wiley started with a 7-minute drive that ended with a touchdown. Central barely had the football in that quarter. Bulldogs have it here, 2nd down and 8. Bear Ming's going to start with a quarterback draw on the right side. Breaks the first tackle, and not much gain there. Didn't have any blockers out there to help him, but Bear makes something out of nothing as he broke that first tackle. Depend on a spot. Looks like he's got about 5, maybe 6.
Yeah, he had a second effort there. He got by, took out an official, a couple other Bobcats in the way, picked up a few more yards, made it a much manageable third down.
Down about 2 now here for the Bulldogs. Been very content to run the football here in the second half. 340 yards of total offense. Now here for Wiley. 3rd down and 2 here. Being handed off up the middle. Boy, it'll depend on a spot. Is that Julius still back there? Yeah, Lane. Looks like he will come up short. 4th down and about 1. Boy, it's really tough. I would like to think the percentages would be high here to get a first down, but with a 16-point lead, well, Bulldog offense can stay out there.
You know, we've had a lot of success with Bear getting underneath the center.
Yep. He might punt. We've seen him punt the football out of this formation too.
Yeah.
Yeah, 4th down and 1. And Bear will punt the football away. Nobody back deep for the Bobcats. If this will take a Wiley bounce, and it does, it's going to end up down inside the 20-yard line. Perfect execution of the quick kick punt. Gage Hyten downs it at the central 18-yard line. That's a way to flip the field in a hurry. So 10:58 left on the clock. And again, Wiley in control here at 30-14. Bulldogs with 341 yards of offense, 143 on the ground, 198 through the air for a total of 341. Central at 249 yards of offense, 150 rushing, 99 through the air for 249. Long field ahead of them here. 1st down and 10. They'll start on their own 18-yard line. English take the snap. He'll hand it off Brawley. Trying to stretch left. He'll cut it up between the hash and the numbers. Able to get out across the 25. Good tough run for Brawley. That's probably his best run of the night. He's got 8 on that one. And again, I keep thinking back to last year. Man, we're like 60 points behind behind the pace we were on last year.
Yeah, and all those, this second half's gone so fast. Plenty of restaurants are going to still be open.
2nd down and 2, balls at the 26. English has pressure, flares it out. Brawley in the flat. Makes a catch. He's across the 30, breaks a tackle. 35-40, he's up the far sideline. Garrett Allison, the defensive end, will chase him down. Late flag flies as well. 23 on the play. I think this might be a face mask, too, as Brawley made that catch. We'll wait and check. Yeah, and it is. So 23 on the completion. Throw on 15 more on the personal foul face mask. Just like that. Don't sleep on the Bobcats quite yet. They're down in Wiley territory just like that with 10-15 and counting. Still down by three scores, but actually just two if you count two-point conversions, down by 16.
Clock is continuing to run. I don't think it's supposed to be, but I'm okay with that.
No, I think he got tackled inbounds, so you mark off the yardage and then go ahead and roll it again. On the 36, English, get rid of it in a hurry. Boy, missed his receiver on that far side, intended for Lindsey. Just threw it behind him, incomplete.
Good job by Jerpy breaking on the ball. I really anticipate, because it seems like he's taking a little bit of time to get the ball out. Just, I look for one of those little run in front of pick sixes.
Second down and 10. English take the snap. Option coming right, but he reverses field, goes left. Spin move will get him inside the 35. Takes a pretty big lick down on the inside. Josh Patterson, Larry Smith Jr. there. About a 5-yard gain. Third down and 5 coming up. Chance to get off the field here for the Bulldog defense, or at least set up a fourth down. I think the Bobcats at this point might go for it. Third down and 5 at the 32. English now a long look over to the far sideline. Still 10 on the play clock. English is now ready. Third down and 5. Take the snap. Flare it out. Brawley in and out of his hands. Incomplete. Boy, Brawley, I think if he makes that catch, he's got a first down on the far sideline. He just didn't see it all the way in. Decision time here. It's probably a pretty easy decision. Fourth down and 5 at the Wiley 32.
Oh, yeah. It's like those commercials. It's the easy Derek Jeter guy to pick. I was really shocked, though, on how long that they let the clock run down, being down 30-14. And again, the play that was called, I thought, you're right. I think if it's caught, it's a first down. But now you set yourself up with fourth.
Fourth and 5. Almost 6 at the 32. They need about the 26, between the 26 and 27. Pressure coming. Set up the screen, and it's executed well. It's caught by Hill. Hill has a first down and more. Cuts it up at the 20. 15, 10, 5. It's a Central Bobcat touchdown. Perfect play call on the all-out blitz on 4th and 5. Colton Hill takes it 32 yards for the touchdown. It's 30-20. Wiley on top with a conversion to come. And if I'm the Bobcats, I think they're probably going for two here. Boy, just the most opportune time to call the screen. They nailed it. Colton Hill has the touchdown. First touchdown pass tonight for the Bobcats. They will go for two to try to get within 8. So the offense still on the field. Motion into the backfield, whistle, and I believe a false start here on the Bobcats. Boy, that hurts on a 2-point conversion.
Yeah, it hurts now, but it doesn't change what they're going to do, trying to make this an 8-point ball game.
They'll have to do it now from the 7.5 as opposed to the 2.5. Their typical 4 receiver set, twins to both sides. Motion coming into the backfield. English hand it off, and they were going to try to throw it back, but Garrett Allison is all over that. The defensive end wraps up Hill. That'll go for a loss on the play. The conversion is no good. It stays a 10-point spread. They were going to throw it back to English on the far side. Nonetheless, 8:52 left tonight. Our new score, Wiley 30, Central 20. As we take the timeout, this is Bulldog Football powered by Taylor Electric Cooperative. Wiley Bulldog Sports Network, 106.3, the Raider.
At Taylor Electric Cooperative, we are more than just the services we provide. For generations, we have been the link that has connected members to our local community. From those who remember when the lights were first turned on to those who rely daily on our high-speed fiber internet, we are here to make certain that those connections never dim. Because we understand that the most important connection we will ever make is the one we make together. At Taylor Electric, we have provided generations with services for living.
and connections for life.
Whether an organized team sport or walk around your neighborhood, Hendrick Clinic Bone and Joint, Action Sports Medicine, and Action Physical Therapy understand the importance of keeping your family moving. From diagnosis to recovery, our team of physicians, orthopedic surgeons, and physical therapists provide personalized care for sports injuries, joint pain, and more. With state-of-the-art technology and more than 40 years of experience, our team will get you back to what keeps you moving.
And back here to Hugh Sanderford Stadium. Bobcats go ahead and kick this one deep. Nice return out to about the 29-yard line. I believe that's Gage Heighton on the return. And that's where the Bulldogs will set up shop. 30-20. Bulldogs a 10-point lead. 8:44 left tonight here in the fourth quarter. On fourth down and five, Christian English hits Colton Hill on a 32-yard pass. The underneath slip screen worked to perfection. The two-point conversion was no good. That's where we are here at 30-20, 8:44 left. Time to ground and pound and drain some clock here for the Bulldog offense. First and 10 on their own 29. Ming take the snap. He'll keep it as he pulled it from Malachi's belly. Sidesteps a defender. He's across the 35-40. Bear Ming, he's got 12. Little read option. He keeps it himself, and it's Wiley Bulldog first down.
Yeah, great job to keep the chains moving, keep the clock going. Again, Ming, we've started to see him get a lot more comfortable, not only just with the offense, but being able to know when to take off and go.
Remember this time last week, there was 5:50 on the clock. The Bulldogs pretty much milked the rest of the fourth quarter and sealed it with a touchdown. Here's Malachi. He's into the second level. He's into the secondary. Malachi's got 12. Late flag flies. I think this is a face mask. Back-to-back plays, though, by the offense. Double-digit runs, and I think, like I say, add 15 more on a face mask penalty. Conversation between the officials to talk about it, but I think that's what this is. Yep, another face mask here on the Bobcats.
You know, and honestly, Andy, throughout the night, that we've seen a lot of face masks on both sides.
Let's get down to Dustin Tatro, get a view from the sideline, feel from the sideline, Dustin.
You know, the Bobcats have had a couple of big penalties like that that have helped out a lot. Yeah. Can we capitalize on it, though?
Two plays, we're down to the central 32, first down and 10. Ming call for the snap. It's Malachi stretching it left. He's got room, 25-20, another first down with a stiff arm inside the 15. Wrestled down, they'll mark it at the 12. That's 20 more for the senior, Malachi Daniels. Inching close to the century mark. 19 carries, 93 yards, Bulldogs in the red zone.
Great job by left tackle Van, sealing the edge and allowing Malachi to bounce.
7:25 left tonight. Wiley 30, Central 20. Gage Heighton is in the receiving core. He and Cooper Jones split to the left. Hunter Hood on the top side. Lone receiver on the right. Ming, get it out to Jones in the flat. And he's going to be dropped, looks like, for a loss as Central read that play. It's Cooper's fourth catch tonight. But that one will lose a couple back to the 15.
Yeah, and a great job, even though it's quick and you hate losing the yardage. Good job by Cooper catching it. Again, you're going to start seeing the Bobcats trying to punch, strip, get the ball loose, but a great job by staying in bounds, keeping the clock rolling.
Second down and 12, ball at the 15. Still 13 on the play clock, 6:30 on the game clock. Ball's on the left hash, three receivers set. It's in motion across the formation. That's the H-back Underwood. Handoff Malachi, left side. Tripped up right at the line of scrimmage, but falls forward for about four. Clock has stopped. Just have a Bobcat who lost his helmet on the play. Give him a chance to sub out. 3rd down at about 8 at the 11-yard line. Halfway through the fourth quarter. Bulldogs trying to go 3-2 in non-district play. have a three-game winning streak going into District 2-5A play 2 weeks from tonight. Third and eight at the 11. Ming take the snap. It's Malachi off the right guard with a lead block. He's inside the five. Spins around. Did he get in? I think he's just short at the one. Boy, had a great lead block. I think it was Cade Burt. His lead block. He doesn't get in the end zone, but it's a 10-yard gain. It's first and goal at the one-yard line.
Yeah, great job. Again, running the play clock all the way down. Literally, I think one was like a red light, yellow going to red, switching down. Great job by Malachi in the offensive line.
Now does he get to finish it off? First and goal at the one. It is Wildcat. No, Ming's still in. Ming. Take the snap, quarterback sneak, pushing the pile forward. The entire pile is in the purple turf. And it's a Wiley Bulldog touchdown. Had to wait for the official signal, but Hodge, that entire pile was in the purple turf. Didn't matter who had the football.
No, it actually reminds me of a play that we saw last year, but we won't go into that. But great job by Ming. The third time tonight getting under center, quarterback sneak. This time it's for a touchdown.
Spreads it back out to a 16-point spread. Brady Clark's extra point can make it a three-score game. Field goal unit, extra point team is out on the field. Drew Penny calls for the snap. It's back, it's down. Brady's extra point is up and good. 4:43 left tonight, our new score. Wiley 37, Central 20. We take the timeout. Bulldog football powered by Taylor Electric Cooperative. Wiley Bulldog Sports Network, 106.3, the Raider.
At Borland Soben & Partners, we're in our third decade of providing high-quality, affordable dental care in Abilene and the Big Country. Our family-friendly clinic offers comprehensive dental care for adults and children. Anything from hygiene and preventative care to cosmetic dentistry and dental implants. And don't worry, we do emergency services too. Our team of professionals understands the latest dental techniques and technology and welcome your questions as we develop the perfect treatment plan for you. And best of all, we offer same-day appointments if you're in pain. So schedule your appointment today, and we'll see you soon.
Bear Ming caps off a 71-yard drive, 4 minutes off the clock here in the fourth quarter. 37-20 Bulldogs. Here's Brady Clark's kickoff. And this one will go out of the back of the end zone. And it's a touchback. Malachi's last run put the senior over 100 yards rushing. 21 carries, 107 yards now for Malachi. Ming with the touchdown. 1 yard out. Hodges, it's been a good homecoming 2023, you know what?
Oh, it's been really good. Balance-wise, we've had some great job on the punting team with bounces there, special teams. And again, defensively, continuing to get better, getting used to Coach Cates. And again, Coach Kincaid in the offense, again, putting up a very balanced attack tonight.
First and 10 for English and company. Starting on their own 25. English a straight drop. Bulldogs will play coverage. This is a curl pattern caught on the near side. Caught, immediately tackled. Kenny Scott able to make the tackle. Catch made by Carmelo Amiglio, his first catch tonight. Forward progress will give him 7. It's second down at 3.
And again, long throw across the field gave plenty of time for Scott to make a great play and a tackle.
That clock keeps on winding, 4:15 and counting. English take the snap. It's Brawley off the left side. Has a first down across the 35, out to about the 39. 7 more for Brawley. And move those sticks. Central's lowest point total on the year is 27. They did that versus Colleen Shoemaker in their opener. It's a team that averages 36.3 a game. Bulldog defense has held them to 20 thus far tonight. English straight drop on first and 10. Throw the curl pattern in and out of the hands. Incomplete. Amiglio, again, the intended receiver.
And again, I'm kind of shocked. Now it doesn't matter because the pass is incomplete. But not a whole lot of urgency right now by the Bobcats on trying to get any kind of tempo going with, still down 17.
Bulldogs will play their nickel coverage, 5 in the secondary. Second and 10 from the 39. Play action, get it out hill on the near side. Short gain, another flag flies. Jagan Smith, the tackle here for the Bulldogs.
You want to put a guess on what that flag is?
We've seen a lot of this flag tonight. A lot of grabbing that metal around the face. I can't believe we have another face mask. Give us a chance. Let's go down the sideline. Let's visit with Dustin Tatro. Dustin?
You know, seeing Baird just get more versatile on these offensive plays and getting our defense in the right place, man, that's the keys to the game we talked about earlier.
We nailed it. We were all over it tonight. 3:35, the clock runs. Wiley 37, Central 20 on the scoreboard.
And again, clock running, Andy, and not a whole lot of urgency. Yep. Maybe they know the spread.
It's English call for the snap. Take the snap, hand off Brawley. And Brawley able to push forward. He's got another first down all the way to the Wiley 30. That's 11 more for Brawley. 9 carries, 38 yards tonight for Brawley. Also has 3 receptions for 40. First and 10, Bobcats on the Bulldog 30-yard line. Under 3 minutes we go. English, pump fake, air it out, far sideline. Deep ball, underthrown, it's intercepted. There is a flag down. We'll check the flag. On a stop and go, just underthrown and intercepted by Jake Bearden. But again, a flag on the play. Waiting. A pass interference called here on the Bulldogs. So that will negate the interception. Not sure who the corner was on the far side. Bearden, the free safety, came over and made the interception. But all negated on the Pest Patrol penalty flag. Just like that, Central down inside the red zone. First and 10 at the Wiley 15. But just 2:48 to work with in a 3-score game. Wiley 37 and Central 20. English, fake the handoff. He'll keep it himself. Right side, inside the 10, inside the 5, dives for the pylon, and he got in. English from 15 yards out. It's a Bobcat touchdown. Don't go away quite yet, folks. 37-26, conversion to follow. I tell you, English is something special.
Oh, no doubt. Again, I can't reiterate what Andy just said. Don't leave anywhere. Don't change the channel. We have been in way too many crazy games, so stay with us for sure. But, again, English just so versatile. And, again, keeping it on the ground into the end zone.
Parra's in for the extra point. It is on the way, and it is good. 2:39 left, our score. Wiley 37, Central 27. So we take the timeout. Wiley Bulldog football powered by Taylor Electric Cooperative. Wiley Bulldog Sports Network, 106.3 The Raider.
When First Financial Bank opened its doors in 1890, a relationship between a local community bank and a state was born. For more than 130 years, First Financial has grown alongside you, your family, your business, all while putting your goals first. From the ports to the plains. First Financial Bank, Weir, Texas.
When it comes to finding the right vehicle for you, there's no better place than Lawrence Hall in Abilene. For over 34 years, Lawrence Hall in Abilene has been the place to find the best from Chevrolet, Buick, and GMC. And that is still true today. Great products and great service, too. So the next time you need a new car, truck, or SUV, come see us or shop 24/7 at LawrenceHallAbileneOnline.com. Voted Abilene's best new car dealer for over 28 years by you, our customers.
Bulldogs anticipating an onside kick here. 10-point lead, 2:39 to go. Got the hands unit on the field. Here is the kickoff. It is an onside kick. Covered up nicely by the Bulldogs. Jaden Lucero all over it. So not only do the Bulldogs keep possession with a 10-point lead, they've got good starting field position. Central, a six-play, 75-yard drive. Christian English scores his second touchdown of the night on 15-yard run. He's got 11 carries, 150 yards on the ground. 37-27, 2:39 on the clock. Lucero is in. Check that. Keegan Anderson is in at the quarterback spot. Jaden Lucero is offset to his left. Take the snap. It's Lucero. Good, tough run. He's into Bobcat territory to the 47-yard line. Kevin Crane's going to go ahead and burn a timeout here, try to save a little bit of time on the clock. Timeout with 2:33 left. That run by Lucero puts the Bulldogs over 400 yards of total offense tonight. And pretty balanced, Todd. Look at this. 206 rushing, 196 passing.
Wow.
402 total.
Again, and other a lot of a number of guys getting involved tonight. You've seen, we talked about Cooper Jones, obviously Derek Evans, big first half, Riley Robinson. It's just been really good seeing again. Can't emphasize enough, getting Juju back in the lineup tonight was nice. He's looked good. Lucero, of course, Malachi. So really good offense tonight and a great job by the offensive line up front.
Look at the out-of-town scoreboard. Again, Andrews beats Lubbock High tonight, 55-21. It's a final in Hereford. Plainview's lost their first game of the year, 24-21. Hereford beats Plainview. Stephenville beats Wichita Falls Rider, 21-20. How about that?
I bet Gentry was involved in some of that.
Got some new receivers in the receiving corps here. Peyton Stone is in. Drew Penny is in. Again, Keegan Anderson at the quarterback spot. He can take the snap. It's a handoff. It's Jagan Smith. Jagan, a big tough run inside the 40. He's to the 39. That boy, that junior run's tough. There's eight for Jagan. Wiley Bulldog first down.
You know, Jagan got to play a little bit last week in the Stephenville game.
Yep.
And did a really good job. Real wiry. Kind of reminds you of Landry Carlton. It would, but you know, just a little wiry and takes off. And really good job. And it's great to get these kind of minutes for a junior.
Another timeout here for the Bobcats with 2:26 remaining. 37-27 Wiley. A few other scores from the district. Paladuro's about to, well, they're closing in on a win. They lead Canyon Randall 35-21. Paladuro will be here at the end of October. Permian leads Abilene Cooper 41-20. So it looks like the Cougs are going to drop to 1-4 in their non-district portion of the schedule. We'll be at Shotwell Stadium the last game of the year. Southtown Showdown over Shotwell, early November.
Get to hang out and check out the new digs I got over there, new press box.
Looking forward to it, man. Heard nothing but great things about the new digs. First and 10 Bulldogs on the Central 39. Take the snap, it's Smith again. Run up to the 36. He's got about three on this carry. And the final timeout for the Bobcats. Give us a chance. Hey, let's go down. Hey, Dustin, how you doing down there, man?
You know, I'm wondering if some of these offensive changes are like when you bring a catcher in to pitch when you're doing, I don't know. Can they do anything with 10 points in 2 minutes? Hey, let them get out there and play.
Hey, did you find a garter yet?
I have not. No, no one has been nice to me.
I'm sorry, Dustin. I'll pull it. We'll make that. We're adding that to next year. We'll make that happen. I'm tired of listening. Hodge has this big garter on up here, and those little bells are dinging. And
I want I want one of these Chef Jeff shirts. They're actually pretty cool.
Yeah, it's a good look. It's a good look.
Yeah, it's not me coughing. It's my garter belling.
2:18 left. The Bobcats just used their final timeout. Grant White is also in the receiving corps here for the Bulldogs. It's Anderson again at the center. Second down and 8. Take the snap. It's Smith again. Bottled up right at the line of scrimmage. Might have even lost one here. Forward progress. He'll lose one. But no timeouts now for Central, so that clock will continue to wind. Third down and 9 at the Central 38-yard line. With just the 2 minutes left and a 10-point lead, I tell you what, it's crazy here that the Bulldogs' non-district schedule will be exactly opposite of what it was last year. We're 2-3 after the Central loss. This year will be 3-2, but all 5 games with different outcomes from a year ago. It's crazy. Coy Wayne Holcomb is at the left guard here. Get a couple of snaps. I believe it's Marco Sainz who's in at the right tackle. Here's Smith stretching to the left side. Oh boy, he's really close to a first down. He stepped out of bounds at the 30. That's going to be a yard short. Did they give it to him? Yeah, they did. He got 9 on the play. They needed 9. He got 9. It's a Wiley Bulldog first down, and that should be the final one of the night. Should be victory formation for the last 1:23. And I tell you, 3 weeks ago, Hodge, I know we walked out of this booth going, what is this 2023 team going to have in them?
Right.
And here we are 3 weeks later going, you know, there's a lot in them.
Well, and we mentioned it, having to get used to, whether it's defensive coordinator getting used to the kids he has, the kids getting used to who he is. You have a new quarterback coming in with Bear Ming and even having to get used to who he's throwing to. And then you lose one of your top weapons in Regala early, and then now it makes other guys having to step up and fill the roles, and we've seen that with Hood and Evans and Robinson. And so, and again, it's really great to see these guys doing that. And I think a lot of us, even us, whether it's in the booth, coaching staff, the bye is at a good time. You get another full week to get Regala healthy. Maybe it looks like maybe Evans as well. And so just kind of regroup. And the important thing is going to be, how do you handle that when you come back from the bye?
So 37-27, it's victory formation time here for Keegan Anderson and company. Keegan will take the snap. He will take a knee. Bulldogs about to celebrate homecoming 2023 with a win. Move to 3-2 on the season. Stay with us here. We're about to have the Animal Health and Medical Center postgame show. We'll get to our Abilene Glass and Mirror player of the game as well. And it looks like we might need one more snap of the football to make this a final. Central will drop to 1-4. They've got a tough District 2-6A schedule ahead of them. The likes of Odessa Permian, Midland Legacy, Friendship. Some tough ones on their schedule. Keegan will take one more knee. And that will do it. Good solid win again. Second straight week. It's a 10-point spread. Last week it was 42-32. Tonight it will end at Wiley 37. San Angelo Central 27 as the final seconds tick off of this one. And Wiley gets the win again to move to 3-2. We'll take a quick timeout. We'll get into the Animal Health and Medical Center post-game show. This is Wiley Bulldog football powered by Taylor Electric Cooperative, the Wiley Bulldog Sports Network, 106.3 The Raider.
Everyone should have access to a bright financial future, because when everyone succeeds, we all do better. That's why Abilene Teachers Federal Credit Union provides the tools and resources to help make your dreams come true. From buying your first home to taking the vacation of a lifetime to saving for retirement, we're here to help you achieve your goals. We serve everyday people in everyday life.
The best tailgates start with the best beef. And the best beef starts with United Supermarkets. United Supermarkets, where we do beef the best.
...37-27, the Bulldogs victorious. You're getting a look at a few of the highlights from tonight as Wiley gets the win and now back here as the Bulldogs celebrate again. 37-27, the final score. Hodge, it was all systems go from the beginning. Just offense was great. Defense gets a turnover in the very first series of the night, and before you know it, we're out of the chutes and running and kept Central at arm's length all night long and moved to 3-2 on the year.
Well, and again, you mentioned it, the great, quick, fast start that we had, scoring just about on every drive that we had, whether it was field goals or whether it was, you know, we had the field goal and then touchdowns. So just a really great job offensively tonight, defense. And again, you mentioned it, we started 0-2. Now what, we're on a three-game winning streak with a bye to come. A really great homecoming night, and I appreciate that. I mean, congratulations to the seniors, coaching staff, getting to celebrate a homecoming win tonight.
411 total yards of offense for the Bulldogs tonight, 215 on the ground, 196 through the air, and it was kind of a combination of two different halves. It was a lot of pass in the first half to build the lead and then a lot of run in the second half to maintain the lead, shorten the game. And, man, just, you know, when the Bulldogs needed to make plays, they made plays and they were able to do that tonight.
And honestly, I thought one of the biggest plays, because I think it could have changed and tweaked momentum a little bit, was the third when it was 30-22 and they went for two and didn't make it a one-score game. I thought that was a huge play, kind of maybe squashed some of the momentum that was going to the Central side. And again, just a really great team win tonight, and the offensive line fantastic tonight.
And a week off moving ahead, and Plainview is now 2 weeks away. District 2-5A play is 2 weeks away with the Plainview Bulldogs on the road coming up. Bear Ming tonight, 16 of 24, 196 yards, three touchdown passes on the night. His touchdowns go to Riley Robinson, Derek Evans, and Hunter Hood, all get in the end zone with the receptions tonight. Derek, four receptions for 102 yards and a touchdown, all of that in the first half, did not play in the second half. Riley Robinson, three for 38. Malachi Daniels had four for 29. Cooper Jones had four for 17. Hunter Hood had one for 10, a 10-yard touchdown catch there in the third quarter of play. On the ground tonight, Malachi Daniels gets over the century mark. 21 carries, 107 yards, and the touchdown. Bear Ming on the ground, 11 for 46. Julius Lane, 9 for 34. Jaden Lucero had 5 for 19. Jagan Smith had 4 for 19. On the night. So, good night of offense. As you can hear the school song here, the Wiley Bulldogs.
Yeah, and again, just a really great job tonight of offensively doing all the things well. And one of the other things I liked about tonight is you got to get some kids some reps. Jagan Smith being able to run the football, showing, hey, allowing that depth at running back to be big, and also the depth at wide receiver tonight was huge as well.
So, Hodge, let's get into our Abilene Glass and Mirror Player of the Game here in the Animal Health and Medical Center postgame show. Abilene Glass and Mirror Player of the Game. On nights like tonight, man, there's so many to choose from. We said the same thing last week in Stephenville. We can say the same thing here tonight. Our Abilene Glass and Mirror Player of the Game, we'll give you your thoughts for who that is tonight.
Well, and again, I know he didn't play the second half, and I know it's called the player of the game, but really set the tone early. Yep. And I think Derek Evans, again, huge catches, not only the big touchdown catch, but extending some drives. And again, Derek very much in the mix of it last week as well. But again, I give it to Derek Evans. Great receiving, great night for a senior. And so congratulations to him on being our